carries that kind of strength more than anyone other than Tiger in the last 40, 50 years. And it's playing out this golf season. And the Scheffler resume is very quickly being compiled impressively. We'll see what fatherhood does. That makes a difference for some. It changes your perspective. It changes your availability at some times. It times can change your commitment and your commitment level. And Scotty, famously, he and his wife are about to welcome their first child into the world. There was some concern that call could come during the Masters. And Scheffler, this gives you an indication of what kind of commitment he's going to have. You know, he said all along, look, I could be leading, walking up the fourth fairway. If the call comes, I'm going. So that's kind of the mentality that he'll approach fatherhood with. So that remains to be seen. But in the here and now, he is waving a magic wand out on tour. Just dominant in winning the Masters for the second time. I think if there is a second top story to be taken from Augusta and this year's first major, it is Ludvig Åberg. It's a young cat. And playing in his first major. And the last year, he was playing college golf this time last year, gang. And what he's done since then, he's won on the European Tour, was named to the European Ryder Cup team where he went 2-2, then won on the PGA Tour, Sea Island in the fall. He has been a mainstay on PGA Tour leaderboards this year, hasn't won yet this year, or this calendar year. But he's contended. He's contended in a bunch of weeks. And to play that golf course as a first-timer, I think Fuzzy Zeller, the last to win it in his first appearance, and we're going way back to the 70s, I believe. And so I think Åberg is a story to take out of that. And other than that, that top man, they're just, they're going to have their weeks. The rest of the Schaufelys and the Morikawas and, other guys that weren't necessarily flashing this week. There's just such a clear-cut hierarchy in PGA Tour golf right now, and at the top of that hierarchy, and it's really no debate, and he is slamming the door shut on debate, in fact, and that is a Scottie Scheffler at the top of the heap. And with a win yesterday at the Masters, Scottie Scheffler's caddy is doing better than most pros on tour right now, just from these three tournaments alone: Bay Hill, the Players, and the Masters. Scottie Scheffler has won what? He's won 4.5 for the Players, 3.5 for the Masters. That's 8. Another 4 for Bay Hill. That's $12 million. So the typical rate of exchange for a caddy, if it's a first-place finish, you get 10%. Do the math. It's mid-April, and Scottie Scheffler's caddy has already made $1.2 million. Just on the first-place checks, by the way. We'll factor in some other base salary. We'll factor in some other finishes on tour. But, yeah, maybe the second best position in golf right now behind Scottie Scheffler is, Scottie Scheffler's bag. We used to say this about Stevie Williams. It's always a fun fact at the end of a dominant year to find out how many people on the PGA Tour money list will finish behind Scottie Scheffler's caddy. That's how good dude is playing. We got a lot more going on in sports, a lot to talk about today. When it comes to the Masters, we are live at Hidden Hills, where the GM and director of golf, Russ Libby, is once again our host and has a terrific perspective on pro golf and on the Masters. We'll talk a little bit about his golf course here, what we can expect. That's not a baby, Ruth. That's all I'll say. And we'll do that coming up next segment. And so lots of golf sprinkled in today here at the Guggen. See, I'm smart, and I've got a PGA Tour pro in my back pocket. So Matt Every will be in my group, and Matty will be out here a little bit early before we get going today, and he'll join us in the 9 o'clock hour and give us his perspective on this year's Masters and this dominant aura that Scottie Scheffler is emanating these days. NBA basketball now heads toward the postseason. This I can now definitely say. The play-in is, I don't like the play-in. I've been chided, by some for not saying, that's dumb. So I'm going to try and get off of that, whether it's dumb, smart, or indifferent. I don't like it. It's a waste of time in the East. The Bulls and Hawks stink, the Hawks in particular. Why make the 7-8 who earned the 7-8 over the course of 82, why make them go play a throwaway game? where a player could be. Do you want to put Joel Embiid or Jimmy Butler in a situation before you go into the playoffs where they get injured for no reason? Does anyone with half a basketball brain really think that either the Chicago Bulls or Atlanta Hawks can win a series, much less the title? Now, maybe it's a counter-argument out west. So this year, the 9 and 10 end up being Sacramento and Golden State. Think about that. Those are two really good basketball teams. But you know what? They weren't good enough to be in the top eight. So go on home, and we'll see you next year. I don't like it. I think eight is more than enough to decide who the best teams in each conference are. But the brackets have some interesting matchups, and we will parse through those probably in the 10-minute drill coming up just a little bit later on. Gator spring game this weekend. I watched the whole thing. I've digested the comments. I've looked at the stat sheet. I can give you my observations on the 2024 Gator football season. I noticed that Steve Spurrier gave his prediction as to what he thinks Florida's record is going to be. I'll share that with you coming up here in just a bit. Quick hitting thoughts, though. Florida was what, 6-6 last year? And 5-1 at a point? No, they weren't 6-6. What am I saying? They were 5-7. 5-1 and lost the last six. This year's team is going to be better. Now, the schedule's tougher. Just because they're better doesn't mean they automatically win the games they won last year, and the other ones that they were close, they might, in turn win this time around. But first and foremost, let's just start at the quarterback position where both QBs played great. Graham Mertz just proved again that he's the better, more veteran, perfectly capable option. Two touchdown passes or two passing plays of over 50 yards in the spring game. They had one such play all last year. So some of the things that Billy Napier has been saying in the spring played out. You know, they feel the offensive line's better. They want to take more shots downfield. As always, the spring game, there are guys that catch your eye. So I'll just give you a quick version. These are the guys that caught my eye. DJ Lagway caught my eye. Big, strong kid. The light switches, it seems, you know, when the competition ratchets up. And to be his first experience in a game like that, I thought he was very good. He's going to be a dual-threat quarterback. He actually would have run for more yards than the stat sheet shows. In college football, if you are sacked, it goes against the quarterback's rushing numbers. And down in Gainesville, they had an awful quick whistle when it came to what was called a sack. They were, you know, two-hand touch sacks so that no one gets hurt. So he was discredited, I guess you would say, with a sack that probably in many cases wouldn't have been a sack in the play. But besides that, he showed poise. You know, he's running the offense. The play clock's not ever down to 3-2-1. Hurry, get it off. The backup quarterback position is so much better right now with no experience with Lagway that jumps out at you. All right. The Gators, kind of quietly, you're paying so much attention to Lagway and some of the other recruits, but very quietly, in December, I think, it was later in the process, they went and got this freshman, Jaden Ball, okay? He's a running back. They beat Alex from Georgia. They beat Alabama for him. He was down to Alabama and Florida, and you just don't, you know, take note. After the spring game, you took note. Jaden Ball is a big, fast, elusive running back, and he averaged about 7 yards a pop the other day. He stood out. Marcus Burke stood out. You know, the Trinity Christian grad feels like he's been down in Gainesville an awful long time. I think he's still just a sophomore, maybe a redshirt junior. Made plays. Billy Napier spoke of his improvement throughout the course of the spring and what's expected of what Billy calls 88 moving forward. Trey Wilson is a stud. Going to be an NFL player. He's got one more year in Gainesville. Enjoy him this year. They fed him the ball, and as Billy Napier said, post-game, post-orange and blue game, we're going to get our money worth out of Trey Wilson. He's bulked up a little bit and is going to be a really – he's as good a skill position player as they've had down there in a while. So offensively, that's kind of what caught your eye. Both quarterbacks, Jaden Baugh and Marcus Burke as the receiver you're hoping to step up, and Trey Wilson, the receiver that you have a pretty good idea just exactly what he is. Defensively, I thought it was a couple of kids from Jacksonville. You know, Pup Howard, they've been raving about. He was all over the field, made some plays. Sharif Denson from Bartram Trail had an interception in the game. And the defense overall looks better. They look more athletic. They're more experienced. Now, how does this translate? I don't know. I can't trust the opinion and the narrative and the quotes that are coming out of Gainesville. I don't know. I'm going to have to see them on the field. We had a field goal attempt the other day, 10 men on the field. That's not exactly buttoned up, cleaned up, and ready to go. You know, the defense forced a lot of – they had to try like 7 field goal attempts. That means your offense is bogging down in the red zone. Also means your defense is holding. Therein lies the duality of a spring game. But more orange and blue. But that's like – there's the hot list for you right there. Again, I watched the whole game, and I think that's what stands out. And you don't know is about the depth, and some of the names are going to become more familiar as we get more reps. Quite frankly, in today's day and age of college football, the turnover on these rosters is eye-popping. We can put it that way. Major League Baseball now is easing into its schedule. Everybody now is, what, play 10, 15 games? The Braves are scuffling along, man. I mean, to be 9-5, you don't just dismiss that kind of start. Where this team would be right now in the early season without Marcell Ozuna, gosh, who knows? Ozuna did it again yesterday. Had a big double, drove in a run late in the game yesterday, and then in the ninth, down to his last strike, 0-2 count. Braves down by a run. Ozuna hits a 3-run homer against his former team, the Marlins. He leads Major League Baseball in RBI with 21, and he's tied for Major League Baseball's league lead in homers with 7. So, paging Olsen and Riley and Acuna and Albies, paging Harris and, you know, all the other bats in that Braves lineup, it's Marcell Ozuna, who it will now be my one claim to fame as a Braves fan. I'm the only one, Braves fans. Last year at this time, y'all wanted Marcell Ozuna putting a slingshot and pew, shot into the sun. And with consistency and conviction, I wanted to keep Marcell Ozuna around, and thank goodness they did. 40 homers a year ago. What a pace he's off to now. There's other baseball news and notes for sure to pass along. Yankees are off to a terrific start. They did lose yesterday, but overall, the Yankees are off to a terrific start. There are certainly some surprise teams early. The Pirates, the Brewers. In fact, if you looked at one thing through the Major League standings, I think, through, what are we, 3 weeks in now? The biggest surprise of the surprises to me would be that the best division in baseball right now, National League Central. Raise your hand if you had that one. I believe all 5 teams are over, or is there 6 teams? I believe every team in the division is over 500. If not, all but one is, and the one that's not may be a game under, and the Brewers and Pirates headline that list. So we'll get you up and rolling here on the Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com. We'll visit with Russ Libby, GM and Director of Golf here at Hidden Hills, as we preview this tradition like unlike any other. It's the Guggen Open, which will tear up the golf course, either literally or figuratively. This morning is the most appropriate tee time in the history of golf. Of course, what time are we going off, E?
10:10, my boy.
You bet. That makes sense. How was your weekend? What'd you do?
A whole lot of nothing. I just
had a boy.
I hit the beer loop on Friday.
Yeah, okay.
He hard hit the beer loop, did a whole bunch of that. You know, I'm trying to.
You were styling. I saw you. You definitely looked like a golfer. Then you sent Hicken and I a photo that it was just a still photo. I don't know where the ball went, but it was a good pose.
That's all it was, too. It was a good pose. That ball went swimming. Bloop.
Did you hit a good shot at all while you were there?
No, man, and I was trying. Yeah. You know, over
that's
there,
a tough sport, man. You have a new respect for golf?
Oh, man, I am, man. I'm gonna get it, though. I'm gonna get it over there on that green.
Yeah. I got faith in you. Well, after today's Guggen, we'll have your charity event. That's coming up at the end of May.
Yes,
so,
sir.
You know, we work on the game before then. How about that?
Sharpen the skills, man.
Yeah, we'll sharpen the skills. All right, let's come back. E, pull me a Scotty Scheffler on winning another Masters, and we'll hear from the Masters champion when we come back. Also talk with Russ Libby, and there's some NFL talk. I'm definitely fatigued at this point, man. Let's just have a draft and pick some players, right? I'm tired of looking at mock drafts. I'm going to get my hopes up that a certain player is going to be there, and then inevitably, when the actual draft takes place, the mock drafts end up looking kind of silly, some of them. Like, we're going to see guys in the mock draft that are in the middle of the first round that are not going to go to round 3, and then we're going to see guys go in the top 15 that you're like, what? What? Who's that? So I'm getting a little bit of fatigue, but meanwhile, we'll keep doing that mock thing as we motor right along. So thanks for being up and at 'em with us. You're listening to The Drill on 1010XL, 92.5 FM. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback. DivorceMenOnly.com is where we broadcast live from Hidden Hills.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. It's the fastest sport on four wheels.
This is what I've been waiting for.
This Sunday at Talladega, brought to you by the Plumbers and Pipefitters Local Union 234. From the station with the most horsepower, 1010XL.
Let How Does Mazda find the perfect Mazda SUV just for you? Lauren Brooks here. Transition from city streets to off-road trails in a newly leased 2024 Mazda CX-50 for only $316 a month. Or lease the stunning 5-passenger 2024 Mazda CX-30 for only $298 a month. Our professional non-commissioned sales team always puts your best interest first. Plus, every vehicle purchase comes with 2 years free maintenance. Visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com for the Hodges Mazda difference. See dealer for details, lease terms, and fees for qualified applicants expires April 30th, 2024.
Hacker here, and I'm loving the doors that are now opening now that I'm down almost 50 pounds. Oh yeah, and those results are in just 7 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. By doors, I mean opportunities I've avoided because of my weight, like an all-day adventure to SeaWorld or spending 3 days at Walt Disney World. Did I gain the normal 5 to 10 pounds I would have at Disney? Of course not. In fact, I lost 3 pounds last week at Disney, thanks to the good folks at Awaken 180. Awaken 180 travels with you, and I'm eating all sorts of foods, salmon, ground beef, broccoli, cabbage, collard greens, you name it. It's not a lie when I say I'm eating to lose weight is the only way to lose weight. Do what we all did, Matt, Mike, and myself. Call Awaken 180 Weight Loss, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or go online, awaken180weightloss.com.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement, plus no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Denny Thompson here. Tackle burglars and protect your turf. Give yourself peace of mind catching everything around your home with Tyson Sound & Security's cutting-edge surveillance cameras. For safety and convenience, Tyson has you covered for all home cameras and security systems. I'm talking HD recording, night vision, and remote alerts all from your phone or computer. Call Tyson Sound & Security right now at 904-762-1000. Tyson Sound & Security, security and automation experts.
Hey, Scarline here. Tired of missing out on the conversation due to hearing loss? At Jacksonville Hearing and Balance, their team of audiologists led by Dr. Douglas Green can help you rediscover the joy of connection. Visit jhbi.org today.
The Jaguars radio home, 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
Does the building you go to work in every day need a little love and attention? Jason Parker here with Performance Painting. Great companies take great care of the buildings their staff and customers walk into every day. If the building you're in doesn't match the vision you have for your company, we can help. Go to performance-painting.com. Our highly trained team makes the difference. Quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
If your ride is making strange noises, don't wait and make it worse. Come to Action Transmission on Merrill Road. My expert technicians can diagnose the problem and likely fix it fast. Experience the difference at Action Transmission on Merrill Road.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit UA234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Instant Keys, you don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you.
Instant Keys saves the day if you have lost or broken keys. They can program new keys and remotes for nearly every make and model of vehicle. at a fraction of the dealership cost. Fast, honest, and reliable locksmith service. Call 722-1111.
Instant Keys. Instant Keys. You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you.
We're in Florida, and pest problems are persistent. Want them gone? Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions. Veteran and locally owned and operated, Mission Pest will blow your mind with their communication and response time for all your pest, termite, and mosquito needs. Text or call 904-944-PEST. You'll speak directly with the owners. Mention 1010XL when you call 944-PEST. You'll get 25% off your initial pest or termite protection service. Mission accomplished with Mission Pest Solutions.
When you're a little kid on the playground, they tell you don't hit back. Well, the courtroom isn't a playground. And if you've suffered an injury or death in your family, I'm here to tell you it's okay to hit back and fight to make them pay. I'm attorney Brett Hastings. And at Hastings Injury Law, we understand all the pain and emotion that comes with being wrong. And we've dedicated our lives to making things right for people like you. So if you get hit, hit back with Hastings Injury Law. Offices, Jacksonville.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
Sitting around with my buddies this morning, I was a bit overwhelmed because I told them, I was like, I wish that I didn't want to win as badly as I did, or as badly as I do. I think it would make the mornings easier, but I love winning. I hate losing. I really do. And when you're here in the biggest moments, when I'm sitting there with the lead on Sunday, I really, really want to win badly. And my buddies told me this morning, you know, my victory was secure on the cross. And that's a pretty special feeling.
That is Scotty Scheffler with some divine inspiration in addition to a divine golf game closing yesterday with a 68. It made it look too easy, to be honest. Made it look too easy. And wins the Green Jack for the second time in 3 years. Russ Libby is the GM and director of golf here. I guess you're the owner. You're everything. You're the czar of Hidden Hills.
Last I checked, I owned it with my wife. Yes, sir.
You got all the papers. You can prove it if I need to ask you. Yeah. For some reason, you keep inviting us back. So tell us a little bit about this cooperation between 1010XL and Hidden Hills. And we're happy as can be to be back out here.
Well, we are delighted to have you back. We've got 120 golfers coming out here in a little bit. Of course, we're teeing off at 10:10 a.m. But this is a very strong relationship that we've had for many, many years. Mm-hmm. But we are honored to host the Guggen here, and there's a lot of energy, a lot of excitement.
Yeah.
People call months out.
Yeah.
To make sure they get the date.
Okay.
And then the ads start rolling, right? We get people calling, and we direct them the proper ways to sign up. But it's exciting, and people will roll in here early. They always do. We've got the coffee going. The golf course is in great shape.
Awesome.
We're looking forward to having them.
I think people, and as this players grows in stature and in stature, people, there are some golf courses in this town that have carved out their own piece of golf history. And Hidden Hills is one. Talk about the history of this golf course, including the PGA Tour.
Yeah, thanks. We're proud of that. Back in the 70s, we hosted the Greater Jacksonville Open. It was 70, 71, 72. We had some Hall of Famers fortunate that they won the tournament here. So the greats like Tony Jacklin, Gary Player, Don January won out here.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, back in the day, the Greater Jacksonville Open, that was the precursor to what we know now as the Players' Championship. So great history. We've got portraits of all the champions up in the Hills Grill upstairs. Mm-hmm. And what was interesting about that tournament, too, is Arnold Palmer played it for years. He never won it, but he played it, and he told the then-owner, Doc Coppedge, that if you ever want to do anything with this golf course, I want to be part of that. And so sure enough, in the 80s, when they tried to develop the community here, Doc Coppedge called Arnold. Arnold came up, and it's an Arnold Palmer signature golf course now that's weaving in within the community of 550 homes and just a beautiful place. And certainly – it is hidden a little bit, right? It's off the beaten path
for sure.
Over here in Fort Caroline.
And the Hills part, too, makes it one of the more unique places in town. You have a piece of property here. You have a landscape that's not very common in this area.
No doubt. I mean, it tests your game. There's a lot of side hill, downhill, uphill lies. We've got one of the highest points in Jacksonville here behind number 5 green. So it is a little different than what you see in most Florida golf courses.
Well, I enjoy it, and I know everyone's looking forward to getting out there today. Well, I got you. Let me pick your brain a little bit. I think what's most amazing about Scottie Scheffler in this run of dominance, and you know this, and you know this better than I. You're a much better golf technician than I am. It's amazing to me that his consistency holds up the way he moves those feet, man. Forget that it's counter everything. Everyone's got their own deal. I think that Jim Furyk's swing is a lot less alarming than the way he moves those feet. I just don't know how he continues to make this perfect contact every time.
Well, it just goes to show you how talented he is. And I don't think I've seen in my lifetime, 40 years now in the business, somebody with that much motion and movement downstairs like that. But if you look at his stats, tee to green, fairways hit, he was all in the top one or two in most all of that. I think putting was his only nemesis weekend.
Yeah.
I think he was 22 in putting, but still.
Which is better for when he struggles is because the putter doesn't work at all, and he changed to that mallet putter somewhat famously now, and he's won Bay Hill, he's won Players, he's won here, and, man, you know, it'd be silly in a rush to put him in, like, Tiger category, but I will say this. I think as far as how the rest of the field views it, I think he's the first one since Tiger that they kind of feel, man, if this dude plays his best, I don't know if I can win, and it's important in golf, right?
Yeah,
certainly is.
We heard that Wyndham Clark spoke to a group that I'm involved with back at the Players Championship, and you know, he wants to be number one in the world as much as anybody. He works really hard at it.
He's a good player too.
He is. Finished second that week, but he did make the statement too that Scotty's just a little bit better than the rest of us right now, and that means we just have to work harder to try and catch up. And shows it time and time again, right? Other than a 5-footer he missed there a couple of weeks ago, this would be 4 in a row for him.
Yeah, you're right. That's correct. The one tournament that he didn't win in that thing, he was awfully close to winning. Now, the family is going to become a part of his lifestyle, right? And I think he showed his commitment to family when he said point blank, you know, I can be making the turn. If I get the call, I'm leaving at Augusta. So, obviously, that's going to pull away from his focus at times, especially here early, but you know, this notion that, you know, that golfers have kids and then the, you know, success or the talent goes away is kind of silly, right? I mean, you look at the best. Tiger, last I checked, has kids. Jack, last I checked, has kids, right? I mean, such is life, circle of life. He's playing terrific.
Well, he's well-grounded in his faith and his family. Mm-hmm. He knows what's important. He's got great. How can you not like him? He's a great advocate for the game of golf. For sure.
For sure. Well, you're an advocate for 1010XL. We appreciate being out here today for the Guggen Open. And Russ Libby is our generous and gracious host each and every year, and we'll try and take care of that golf course as best we can for you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Jeff. Thanks for being here.
Yeah.
Take care.
Good to see you. Yeah, you bet. All right. Meanwhile, the Florida Gators had their spring game. We talked about that last segment down in Gainesville. I think the hardest thing about a program struggling is that voice that you hear talk, it starts to lose its impact, right? And with Billy Napier, he already kind of has that, you know, country southern drawl, kind of slow speaking and deep voice. It doesn't just pop with it, you know, excitement and pizzazz, that's for sure. And if your football program isn't showing much excitement and pop with the pizzazz, then you know, it almost kind of snowballs on itself. So when Billy talks about what he thinks is better, it's harder and harder for Gator Nation to just fully believe, right? I mean, it's been a rough go. You know, to me, I've always used this joke, you know, going into a football season. The good news for Vanderbilt is they return 18 starters from last year's team. The bad news for Vanderbilt is they return 18 starters from last year's team. You know, because they went 1-10 or whatever the record was that year. You know, and Billy's talking about all these snaps that his guys have had now. And so they'll start this year with some 7,000 snaps or 1,000. I don't even know what it was. The combined snaps of the roster has gone through the roof. Well, here's where the coaching and the development comes in. The team obviously has more athletes and more players than they've had the last couple of years. The backup quarterback position is in much better shape. Steve Spurrier, I saw, says he thinks the Gators are going to go 8-4. You know, he thinks there is going to be improvement. I was saddened that was followed up with, which means they'll have a bunch of Gators doing cartwheels. That's how far, you know, the program has fallen. It's going to take one step back up the ladder before a climb to the heights that you want to go to, that you've proven you can go to, and that climb is going to be harder than ever in this juiced up SEC with no divisions, where there's an Oklahoma or a Texas or a Georgia or an LSU or a Tennessee or an Alabama. Somebody waiting on you every week, man. And never been more competitive. Never been harder to win than it will be now. And part of that is because we've gone right from Alabama's dominance to seemingly Georgia's. And just year in, year out, re-racking and reloading. And so Billy Napier's job in front of him is not going to be easy. That's for sure. But the quarterback situation killed them last year. You know, when Mertz got hurt, listen, it happened late in the year, so I'm not going to say it killed him. It's not, but I got to be honest. And again, this could be just fool's folly. From what I saw from DJ Lagway the other day, if they had DJ Lagway, they'd have beat FSU that night. Well, they'd have a quarterback that could do anything. If they had DJ Lagway, there have been other times in the year where it might have mattered. One thing's for sure, the quarterback room is much improved, and that can't hurt. Mertz is a perfect, you know, final year quarterback to instruct and to mentor DJ Lagway, who has a perfect combination and skill set, to have a package in for him this year. And seemingly early on the composure to take advantage of that playing time when it comes. So here's Napier after the spring game on his quarterbacks.
I mean, I can't compliment those two guys enough. Just to see them, you know, you got a guy, it's like polar opposites, right? You got this guy who started 43 games, he's incredibly aware, smart, different type of player than DJ. And then DJ's obviously, you can see he's athletic, he can play, make plays with his feet. And he has no experience, right? So to see those guys collaborate, to go back and forth throughout the spring, and today you can see DJ's made some progress. Got, you know, just got here in January. So overall, a lot of good today. I do think there'll be things that we can do better.
All right, so there's Billy Napier. And, you know, again, I think overall it looked like an improved football team. It looks like a better football team. They also play in a league that's going to be better with a schedule that's going to be tougher. We'll see how it all translates. He's got to get a bump. I saw one of the national analysts or writers or maybe the guy from Rivals who said, yeah, it's not going to happen. Billy Napier's not going to go 7-5. He's going to go 5-7, and Florida's going to be having a new coach in 2025, so we shall see. Hopefully, it will not be for the best for the program if that's what happens. Whether you believe in Billy Napier or not, to this point, you just certainly want to root for him to show that improvement this year. Of restarting. By the way, not easy just to go get any coach you want anymore. Alabama proved that, right? I mean, guys, stay put. And it's becoming a tougher and tougher job. Something tells me what I saw yesterday in Lexington will be the high point for Mark Pope, the new Kentucky basketball coach. E.T., did you see that?
No.
So they introduce Pope up there in Lexington. They bring him in on a bus, all right, into the gym, and the gym is just absolutely full. Rupp Arena is full. He's introduced in front of a full house at Rupp Arena. Mark Pope. And I can't help it. He walks in. He's holding the national title that he helped win when he was a player at Kentucky. Mm-hmm. He's looking up at this arena, which is just jam full, and they're going crazy. And I thought to myself, get a picture, buddy. This is the highlight. Just doesn't feel like the Mark Pope era is going to be a long, flourishing one at Kentucky. I could be wrong. Gators hitting the portal. They got this Sam Alexis kid from Chattanooga. That's a nice pickup. He's a sophomore. He's a double-double type guy already. He would fill that Tyree Samuel role. And then there's this player, Umar, is it Basso, I think? Or Balo? Yeah, Umar Balo from Arizona is the number one player in the transfer portal, and he's got Florida on his list, and so they're going for a big fish there. The WNBA draft is today. I say this only because the Caitlin Clark, tour will then continue, so expect to see a lot of Caitlin Clark on your timeline in the next 24 hours. Did you see Caitlin Clark on Saturday Night Live?
No, she made an appearance.
Oh, we should probably pull it. I don't know. It's maybe 3 or 4 minutes. I think at some point we should. It was good. It was good. They put her on Weekend Update. And so, you know, Michael Che, one of the Weekend Update anchors, you know, makes a joke about they've retired Caitlin Clark's uniform. They're going to replace it with an apron, you know, that kind of thing. And then So Caitlin Clark shows up, and it kind of looked like he didn't know she was going to be there. And so he's a little bit sheepish. And so she makes some cracks and she writes some quote jokes for him. And he has the same. It was pretty funny. It might be worth playing. Like I said, a little 3 or 4 minute fun time a little bit later in the program. But for now, we will sneak off to break. We'll come back with a football fix. We're live at Hidden Hills, site of today's Guggen Open. And the Hicken arrival is 15 minutes away. We got Fred T. will join us today, talk a little football at 8:30. Matt Every is on site for the Guggen a little later today. He'll give us his master's thoughts. That'll come up in the 9 o'clock hour. And much more. Happy to be up and at 'em with you. I wish you could all be out here with us today. I know there are so many of you out there that have asked me about it, and could we get in, and could we? I really think we could have a tournament for 500-600 golfers today if there was a place on the planet that could accommodate. But we are pleased with our accommodations here at Hidden Hills. Looking forward to a fun day of golf and camaraderie. So, all right, this is The Drill. It's a Monday morning quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
This is Brent Musburger's VSiN Action Update on 1010XL. Brought to you by Duck Duck Rooter Plumbing, Septic, and Air Conditioning. When you're stuck, call the Duck. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Tampa Bay Lightning have already locked out a playoff spot. They're another 75 home favorite against Buffalo today at the Motley Arena. The total is 6 shaded to the over. Buffalo to plus 145 road underdog. Zach Eflin on the hill at Tropicana Field for the Rays today. $1.55 favorite over Patrick Sandoval and the Angels plus 130. 8 over at the Trop. Atlanta Braves, $1.20 road favorite at Houston, plus 100, 9.5 flat, the total at Minute Maid Park. Orlando Magic open up the NBA playoffs, the first round matchup at Cleveland on Saturday as a 4-point dog, 207.5 the total. Free betting splits available at vsin.com/splits. With your action update, Mike Sennett, 1010XL.
Attention all business owners. The raining season is coming and it's important to ensure that your property storm drains are free from debris and functioning properly. That's where Duck Duck Rooter comes in. Our powerful VACCON truck can effectively clean out your storm drains and prevent costly damage to your property from flooding. Don't let clogged storm drains ruin your business and reputation. Call Duck Duck Rooter today to schedule a cleaning before the rains hit. 904-862-6769 or online at duckduckrooter.com.
I'm here with Danny Van Sickle, director of the Electrical Training Alliance. Danny, tell me about your program.
Hey, Rick. We're a 5-year electrical apprenticeship. Our students start out making over $40,000 a year, and right now graduate making over $90,000 a year, including benefits. There is no tuition or no student debt. You just have to apply and get accepted.
Did you say no tuition and no student debt?
You heard that right, Rick. Once you're accepted to the program, your only costs are the books and the course fees, about $800 a year.
That sounds like an amazing opportunity. How can I learn more?
Just go to etajax.org, and you can apply there.
Apply by May 23rd.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Hold on tight, because All Pro Roofing is unleashing some electrifying news. Brace yourselves for instant excitement. Instant roof quotes are here. Simply surf over to their website and hit the Instant Roof Quote tab. Boom! That's your ticket to a lightning-fast estimate. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Click that Instant Roof Quote tab. What are you waiting for? Click on the Instant Roof Quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132705.
CDC 060138.
Hey, Jacksonville, I'm sure by now you've seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We are an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We are committed to customer service, reliability, and have unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today. GFL, green for life.
Weekends were made for sports, and I'll tell you my take on this weekend's best options. Hicken here. Watch for Weekend with Dan on YouTube and Facebook. Weekend with Dan is brought to you by Stone Core. We do outdoors better.
Baloo here for Smunez Vision. Why Smunez Vision? Well, I've been with Dr. Neil Smunez now since I got back to Jacksonville in 2006. 37 years of experience he has. Smunez Vision is a family organization that focuses on personal high-quality medical and surgical eye care. Dr. Catherine Smunez is fellowship-trained in cornea and cataract surgery and all refractive surgery. Combined, that's 30 years plus in laser eye surgery. Visit SmunezVision.com today. Care you can see.
With over 60 years of dedicated service, Big Chief Tire has earned Jacksonville's trust by providing stress-free service at fair prices. Frank Randy here. Whether you drive an electric vehicle or a traditional car, Big Chief carries the best tire brands for lasting quality. Their skilled technicians will install them quickly and have you back on the road in no time. Visit BigChiefTire.com or call 904-932-0950 to schedule an appointment at one of those five Jacksonville locations. Big Chief Tire keeps Jacks rolling.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
Jimerson Burr is a full-service, Florida-based commercial law firm that has experience and capabilities to handle any legal issue a business is confronted with. Learn more about what they can do for you at JimersonFirm.com.
Yo, E to the T here, and we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino, canceled because real life came calling. My Bookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action. All from the comfort of the crib, my boy. I love the live casino. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find the dealers ready to spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience with the actions in your hands, and you don't even need to wear pants, my guy. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL and a revamped loyalty program that'll ensure the host an exclusive VIP perk. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win. Only with MyBookie. Come on, somebody.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time, in fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th, bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena. Guns and Hoses.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, we're back. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback. Sun's up, fun's up. All the 1010XL crew out here scurrying about, getting set up for this year's Guggen Open. We're at Hidden Hills. Shout out to Pops, you know. Holmes is depressed right now. If it's possible to be depressed sitting on the beach in Mexico, then Holmes would be depressed right now. He loves the Guggen Open, not able to make it this year. So, sorry, Dad. Like, he's up listening. I guess it'd probably be like 3 o'clock in the morning there as well. But, you know. Anywho, you know, we usually do the football fix right here. I'm gonna put it aside a little bit, okay? And I'm going to put it aside because I mentioned Caitlin Clark was on SNL the other day. She did a little weekend update with those two weekend update anchors who make the jokes back and forth. And we'll pick it up with Michael Che, one of the weekend anchors, maybe take a little shot at Caitlin Clark. And by watching, I mean, I don't know. Surely he probably did know, did a good job of acting like, gosh, I didn't know she was going to hear that joke. Here's how it unfolded on Saturday Night Live.
The University of Iowa announced that basketball star Caitlin Clark will have her jersey retired and replaced with an apron. Well, the WNBA draft, the WNBA draft is this Monday, and Iowa star Caitlin Clark is expected to be the number one pick. Here to comment is Caitlin Clark.
Caitlin,
But nothing for my joke, whatever. I am a fan, Caitlin, by the way.
Really, Michael? Because I heard that little apron joke you did.
Well, yeah, it was a joke. We're just having fun, you know?
You make a lot of jokes about women's sports, don't you, Michael?
I wouldn't say a lot, but, you know, it's not on the regular.
Yeah, no, it's definitely a lot. I actually sort of made a supercut. Take a look.
Well, no, we don't have to do that.
A number of sports bars around the country are promising to only show women's basketball games during March Madness. The bars are known collectively as the Empty Ones. A new report claims that recent stories on the Sports Illustrated website were actually generated by AI. And it's already making glaring mistakes. For instance, it made up something called the WNBA. Iowa's Final Four game against UConn was the most watched women's college basketball game ever, with 14.2 million viewers, beating the previous record by 14.2 million viewers.
Wow. Colin with the receipts. Thanks, man.
No problem. You know, unlike Che, I support women.
Whoa! No, hold on. I think you're a great basketball player. I mean, I can't play like you do.
Yeah, we know. And obviously, I can't tell jokes like you do.
Thank you for that.
But I did write some jokes, and it would mean a lot to me if you read some of them. Just right over there on the cards.
Well. The Indiana Fever have the first pick in this Monday's draft. A reminder that Indiana Fever is a WNBA team and not what Michael Che gave to dozens of women at Purdue University.
See, now that's a good joke about women's sports. Try another one.
You really wrote these yourself?
Yeah.
Netflix's top new show is Ripley, featuring an eerie, unsettling performance by actor Andrew Scott. Critics say it's the hardest thing to watch on Netflix since Michael Che's special Shame the Devil.
Get it, I like that one. There's more.
This year, Caitlin Clark broke the record for three-pointers in a single season, and I have three-pointers for Michael Che. 1B, 2 funnier, 3 dumbass.
So there you go, E.T. We can bring it back here. And, so, yeah, there's my girl Caitlin Clark throwing some counter punches on Saturday Night Live. We'll queue up a football fix for you, some NFL news a little bit later in the morning. We got Fred Taylor. We got Matt Every. The Sharks back in action this week, so they'll be at home. And we'll perhaps catch up with their head coach, Jason Gibson. That's today, right, E?
Yeah, that's today.
So, yeah, I'll be that in the 9 o'clock hour as well. And
he texted
all this,
me at 5 o'clock in the morning this morning. Right.
All this with the hustle and bustle of the Guggen Open out here at Hidden Hills. So up and at 'em with us. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
Rick Ballew, the truth teller.
You're popular with the public, but I don't have to tell you, I don't have a lot of friends in high places.
Rick Ballew takes you into the night.
It means I got to do a little acting. I'm cool with that.
No acting.
Weeknights on 1010XL.
Mia here, and if you want low payments, then you've got to go to Arlington Toyota Pre-Owned and save today. How does this sound? Just $500 down and only $288 per month gets you a pre-owned 2021 Toyota Corolla. Or you choose a pre-owned 2021 Camry, RAV4, or Tacoma for just $500 down and $388 per month. Plus, Arlington's Credit for Everyone program and 30-day exchange. Don't wait. Save thousands and shop ArlingtonToyota.com today.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
This is the sound of turning small bets into legendary wins. Only on the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook app. The sound of parlays. The sound of paydays. The sound of watching the game will never be the same. Hard Rock Bet has already paid out millions and millions in parlays to people across Florida. Download Hard Rock Bet now, and if your first bet doesn't win, get up to $100 back as a bonus bet.
Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida. Must be 21 plus and physically present in Florida to play. Terms and conditions apply. Concerned about gambling? Please call 1-888-ADMIT-IT.
Home of the Jacksonville Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
I like to be active, and as you get older, I know it because I am older, you're more prone to injury, and I could not get rid of the pain.
QC Kinetics patient Diane Richardson talking about how a hiking injury left her in awful pain.
No one wants to live in pain. I certainly don't want to live in pain. I don't have time for pain.
Diane had heard about regenerative medicine, so she called QC Kinetics and started treatment right away, and the results were incredible.
I couldn't believe it. I honestly was skeptical, but the pain went from a 10 to a 0.
QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in using natural biologics, healing properties from your own body to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. There's no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime.
The result was phenomenal. I mean, I was not feeling any pain. I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
If you have pain from arthritis or injury, this may be the solution you're looking for. Call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
It was a game changer.
904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. 904-274-5522.
Get this thing unwrapped here.
Duval! Pros, what in the world are you doing working on your Duval?
That's right. Dan, I really identify with Duval.
You live in St. Johns County, knucklehead.
I mean the Duval sub, the Daily's Dash Duval. Turkey, ham, melted cheddar, and habanero jack cheeses. Lettuce, tomato, crispy and fresh, you know, like me. I'm sure there's a Daily's Dash sub that sums you up.
The boss.
Because, of course.
Oven roasted beef, Munster cheese, roasted mushrooms, caramelized onions. It's the boss of all subs. Only available for me.
That's just not true.
What do you mean? I walked in the other day, screamed, "You know it!" and said, "A boss for a boss."
Well, no matter who you are, there is a Daily's Dash sandwich or sub for you.
Go find yours. They may even make you a boss.
I'm sure they will, because it is Daily's Dash.
Where more is better.
And you got that right.
Brian and Angela Wall here with Window World. You've heard us talk about it. Window World, the number one window replacement company in the USA, selling over 1 million windows each year for the past 8 years.
That's a lot of satisfied customers, and why J.D. Powers has awarded Window World best in customer satisfaction 3 out of 4 years.
Window World stands behind their slogan, simply the best for less. With Window World, you get top quality windows at a price that leaves more of your money in your bank account, and you get the absolute best guarantee there is in the window replacement industry. When compared to our competition, there is none. See for yourself. Call the competition. Get quotes from them. But before you buy, get Window World's free estimate and compare the quality of the windows and the price.
You'll see.
And when your new Window World windows are installed and they're saving you money on your energy bills, if anything goes wrong with those windows, Window World and I will be there to make it right. That's my guarantee.
Call Window World today. Start saving money on your new windows and your energy bills and take vacation with your savings. Window World, online at windowworldneflorida.com.
Window World, simply the best for less. Thank you for your business.
Window World also offers energy efficient doors and siding.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by Awaken 180 Weight Loss. The annual Orange and Blue game concluded on Saturday afternoon with the Blue team prevailing over the Orange team. Head coach Billy Napier remains high on quarterback Graham Mertz.
I think we're going to look back and we're going to say that it's one of the best things that happened to the University of Florida is Graham Mertz came back for another year while DJ Lagway was a true freshman.
Another Masters is in the book with a repeat winner taking home the green jacket as Scottie Scheffler has won the 2024 Masters tournament. Joining a select group of golfers who have earned the title twice in their career. Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp fell to the Charlotte Knights Sunday afternoon. Charlotte offense got things started in the second and never looked back. Up next, the Jumbo Shrimp will welcome the Norfolk Tide for a six-game set starting at 11:05 a.m. Tuesday at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. At your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, I'm Sam Nelson.
It's 7:03 and it's 60 degrees. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Ladies and gents, please put your hands together as Dan Hicken enters the studio.
Units! Woo! Yes, sir! Yeah!
to expect.
I ain't gonna lie.
Is that a Baby Ruth?
That one hurt me the most.
Yeah.
That one hurt, bro.
Good. Wake up.
I remember one week you came in, you're just as giddy as could be because you just had the great and good fortune to be able to choose Scottie Scheffler. And now I'm feeling that on double because not only did I have the great fortune to choose Scottie Scheffler, but also that second place Ludwig Oberg.
You had him too.
Oh, my God. Had 5.68 million, Hick. Yeah. I'm just out of the cellar. I can just breathe easy for a couple of weeks.
Who's in the cellar now?
Probably the tour.
Probably all tightened up.
What we need to avoid the wheel is just for the tour to be last, but for the drama, for the brand, probably be better if one of us is.
Yeah, it ain't looking good, man.
He's got a date with Destiny this week. He begs to differ.
He does.
Yeah, Destiny arrived.
Yeah, it was a great, great match. Well, it was great, but it got boring on the back nine because Scotty's so good. So nobody really, all the other guys just didn't have, Homa didn't have it. Morikawa, two doubles. Ludwig made one mistake on 11. It almost got the feeling like he was, you know, I don't know. I didn't hear his comments. Like if it was a miss hit, but it just seemed like he was trying to be too fine. And you can't do that at 11.
I think he just pulled it. I think. I don't know.
But if you're going for the pin, then you get less room for error. You got to throw it out to the right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And 11 is a
– That's when you dump it in the middle. I think he's trying to go middle of the green, I guess, what I'm saying.
If you par 11, it's a victory. If you bogey 11, you're okay. It's 500-plus yards. Gosh, those guys hit it so far now. It's still, I mean, just – man, Scottie Scheffler lost it. He's so good. I mean, just fairways and greens and just – hits it in the right spots and just bombs those drives. I mean,
the key though, what made him so much better than everyone else is how high he can hit his irons into those greens.
Yeah.
So he hit them high and soft, and they hit and sit. Everybody else was spinning them all over the place like a pool ball on a table.
But, you know, like 16 great, 14 great. I mean, just knows where to put it. 17 left of the pin or 14, let it funnel down. It's good stuff.
It's hard to hold those greens this weekend, 12, 14. I mean, 14, 17. I'll give you another shot, too, that I've never seen a year where more balls were long on the 12. All hit it over that par 3 green all weekend.
I thought Homa got a little unlucky on that. It kind of skipped off. It hit the green and just kind of skipped and took a shot right into the bush.
Homa couldn't make a putt all weekend. He would have won the tournament.
I'll tell you, he couldn't make a putt. It's DeChambeau. Holy cow. He had short putt after short putt. They would just miss. Yeah. And my son said this. I don't know if it's true because it comes from a 19-year-old, but he did say, he said, Dad, that Masters doesn't give out books on greens. He goes, and normally DeChambeau gets his little, book on the green, and then he does his math analytics, and that's how he figures it out. Couldn't do it.
So he's got to play by feel.
Yes. I don't know if that's true or not, but that's what my son told
me. I think they have – I don't know. Maybe they do. I have no idea. I'm sure he saw it somewhere that was
– But anyway, I did not think he could – I did not think he – putted well either, but he's never played particularly well there, and that 65 was sort of more of an aberration, and then he played kind of par golf the rest, or even over par golf the rest of the way. But it was I said this yesterday, Mrs. Scotty is feeling a pang at Scotty makes the turn up three, you know, do not call Scotty.
That's where
she's not, come on, man. We're not.
They made that up.
Scotty's on 14, and they're going to call him. Hey, she's in labor. Yeah, let him finish and then get him out of there quick. I mean, come on.
That stage doesn't even.
But I did think about that when as he was.
I will say this. The big loser to the Scheffler pregnancy is going to be Hilton Head this week.
Yeah.
Because that's an elevated event. They're all playing this week, by the way. It's a big.
Oh,
yeah,
good.
So they elevated, designated, whatever the – Stewie makes us call it. Signature.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't be surprised with the looming birth that Scotty maybe takes
due like at the end of April anyway.
That's what they said. It was 1 to 3 weeks. They acted like it was going to happen any day.
Yeah, and it's only mid-April, so. But, whatever. It's Texas.
I
mean, he can get
home. I hope he doesn't play. Is the guy now in first? No, yeah. Scheffler. Sounds great to me.
Yeah.
You handicap the field. This guy was a 4.5-1 to win pre-tournament. That doesn't happen, those kinds of odds.
Ooh, what a savvy move here by a degenerate gambler. I'm not going to say who, but Saturday, bogey double or double bogey bogey, and Scotty's odds went to -270, and somebody might have plucked some money down on Scotty right then and there, and
picked up a nice little paycheck yesterday.
Plus 270. But
yes,
yeah.
Plus 270.
So 2.5 to 1. That's, yeah. Not bad.
Yeah.
I would have liked that at that time. I never thought he wasn't winning.
Right.
Even when he started going sideways a little bit on Saturday and fell a couple behind.
Wobbled. Right after that, it was plus 270, and you jump on that. And
never thought he wasn't
winning. Go make yourself some cash money.
And to be honest with you, because I knew what I had in the brunch, at that point, my whole grind was, let me get a solo second with Oberg.
I did notice I won the other thing that we're in and moved into second place. So
nice.
Kind of excited about that. So maybe
I'm hanging around. I'm just kind of hanging.
Find some cash money there.
Sure.
Are we halfway done yet?
No. No. We got a problem. Oh, halfway done with the first half?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, halfway done.
No,
the
no.
Half
we
half.
Got probably 6-8 tournaments.
No, that's too bad.
Until halftime. Yeah, there's 30-something. We've only done about 11.
There's like 17 17 people in that pool, 17, 18. But it's been fun. But, yeah, I mean, kudos. I mean, gosh, fourth youngest to win 2 green jackets. You know, questions you start now asking about Scottie Scheffler are simple ones, and that is how many majors can he win? How long can he maintain? How good of a golfer is he? What, you know, those are the kinds of things you start to wonder about Scottie Scheffler. Is he a Rory, Jordan, 3 or 4 majors, you know, and then see you later? What's he going to, you know, that to me is the interesting thing.
Oh, sure. And, I mean, this is where but I can't help but wonder about those feet, Dan.
I don't know how
you can move those feet like that and keep your consistency. Yeah. And maybe he can, but I got to think if something starts to go off with him, I don't know. We can ask Matt Every later. I don't get it, dude.
Well, I told you it's after they say
it's not.
After.
That's a lie. Well, I looked. It's not after. It starts to – no, they're lying. I mean, not lying. They're mistaken. Those feet start to move before he makes contact, Dan. Before, not after. Before.
I threw a bonus Dreamfinders poll question, and Dreamfinders Homes, the official builder of the PGA Tour. I threw a bonus Dreamfinders bonus poll question of the day and on the weekend. What should Tiger do going forward? Because that was tough. That was a rough watch for fans like us of Tiger Woods who watched every victory, every swing that he had, every comeback, every clutch putt, every the world's greatest golfer. And so I gave you 4 options. Should he retire? Should he play when he can? Should we just enjoy it when he's out there with no expectation, or should he go coach Charlie?
I don't care what I will enjoy it as best I can while he's out there. Yeah. But I'm off the train. You got to practice.
He can't win.
You can't go out without practicing, yeah. Dude. Yeah. Tiger reminds me of this. You know what Tiger reminded me of? Tiger reminded me of every golfer who played this weekend who, when the round finishes, says, if I'd only done this, I could have done that. I never got my A game. This was just off. It's what he is. Now he's just a golfer. Dude shot 82, man. Here's what bothered me worse than anything. I'm not going to give the great and powerful Tiger Woods a pest of the day. I'll never do it. But to tell me it's a good week, boss, you're DAL, man.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? It's a good week? Dude, if the old Tiger heard you right now, he would punch you in the face. A good week. You shot 82. You had your worst finish in your history, and you were DAL at Augusta. VJ beat you by 3 yesterday. It was not a good week. You play like dog do.
Tiger had his
good week, he told me.
When Tiger said going in, you know, the goal is to win. If I, you know, I can still win. No, you could still win in 2019, and you did. That was your moment.
Yeah.
Your moment is
gone. No more.
It's gone. So it was, gosh, and I hope I'm wrong. But anyway, 36% said enjoy him while he's out there. While
Listen,
he's earned the right to do whatever he wants to do.
For sure.
Fine. I guess he's going to try to play the majors. And
he needs to ramp it up and be able to play more.
The first two rounds,
he was fine.
Yeah.
Well, then don't play. You can't just show up. You're going to just embarrass
yourself.
You can't
ramp it up. I always say this about Tiger Woods. I think this is true. I really do. If his name wasn't Tiger Woods, I think he would have one leg. I think they would have amputated his leg accident. I think they knew
he's all upper body, and you can't play golf that way. It's just there's some things now that are – he's not played good golf since that leg injury, and now I've seen enough that I'm done.
He told that the kid he played with, he got up at – 3:45 to prepare for his 9:30 tee time.
Yeah,
with his team. What a, I mean.
Yeah.
Oh,
massages and stretching and just all of it, and you can't do anything, man. Just roll out of the rack and go hit it at that stage.
Anyway, Dreamfinder's Homes.
But as to Scheffler, this is the only caution I have, and I heard you mention Rory, and I heard you mention Jordan Spieth. It's easy to get caught up with how good someone is right now, but I will remind folks that Jordan Spieth in 2015,
right,
at the age of first 21 and then 22 over the course of the summer, he won he won the Masters in 2015.
Mm-hmm.
He followed it up with a win at the U.S. Open in 2015.
By the way, when you say he won the Masters, he dominated the Masters.
18 under.
Yeah,
he tied Tiger's record.
He blew the field
away.
All
right, so Spieth wins the Masters in 2015, wins the U.S. Open in 2015. He's second at the PGA in 2015.
Yeah.
He wins the Tour Championship.
Yeah.
He wins the British Open in 2017.
Okay, so but what?
In 3 years at the age of 24, he's got three majors.
Yes, and by the way.
And a lot of wins.
And nonsense, right?
He won last year or two years ago, but let me see.
No, a major?
No, no more majors.
Three majors. And by the way.
But came close. He came close at the British Open. Remember, he lost to, was it Phil? Did he lose to Phil?
And here's the thing at Augusta. He dominated when he won his green jacket at 21. He was dominating again, like rolling to another green jacket the next year, if I'm not mistaken. And then he went to 12, and he imploded.
Yeah, he jumped
on Sunday at 12, and he hasn't been the same since at Augusta, and another major comes and goes for Rory, who's
Rory's as done as Tiger.
No, Rory. I bet you Rory wins another major.
Yeah,
but
I don't know why.
He was in contention in all four of them last year, but I don't know if he'll win the Masters. I don't know if he does. I don't know if he's got too much demons in his head at Augusta or whatever. I don't know that he can win a Masters, but I will bet.
Yeah,
at
least, yeah.
Rory wins.
Well,
another
that
major.
Would be the smart money for sure.
Yeah.
In 2015, Spieth won.
Oh dear, bless you.
Excuse me. In 2015, Spieth won the Valspar, the Masters, the U.S. Open, the John Deere, the Tour Championship.
Yeah.
At the end of 20, he also won in 2013 the John Deere. So by the end of 2015, mm-hmm. he had just turned 22 years old, and he had six PGA Tour titles.
Oof.
Yeah, then he won again. Then he won again. He won twice in 2016. He won three times in 2017. So from 13 to 17, really from 15 to 17, Jordan Spieth was doing what Scottie Scheffler is doing now. So point being, there's no guarantee.
No.
But you never felt even Spieth at his most dominant was as separated from the tour as he is now.
Yeah.
Like when Spieth was his best, you felt like if Rory played great or Dustin Johnson or Tiger or Mickelson or whoever it was, they were closer to him than these dudes are to Scheffler right now. And those feet just moving around like he's doing a dance
Liv,
USA.
Liv Tour guys didn't have a good week. It doesn't matter. I'm not gloating. I don't care. Like I said, it doesn't bother me as much as it did the first time around. But I do note a sense of I don't think it bothers any of them except Jon Rahm. I think it bothers Jon Rahm. I don't think Jon Rahm's having fun. He looks sloppy and fat.
He wasn't. Yeah, he wasn't good.
I don't.
I could delineate. I could delineate the live guys like this too.
Yeah,
the older guys just went to. They don't give a damn anymore. Like Dustin Johnson can't play golf. I mean, these guys just went and got my money. I'm about to turn 40. I've won. I'm not going to beat Scottie. I'm not winning a bunch of majors. Yeah. And Phil stinks.
Yeah.
I know he made the cut. Whoop-de-doo, whatever. Yeah. Tiger stinks, too. I'd say the same thing about him.
Yeah.
You know, that older.
Like Cam Smith was in contention.
Can't putt. What happened to him? He used to be a great putter. He missed every putt yesterday. DeChambeau played okay. And then Tyrrell Hatton is, whatever. These guys are what they are.
Yeah. So I wouldn't say
I'm kind of past that finally. So glad to be. And at Augusta, what was proven is that whatever tour you align with, whatever style of golf you like to watch, the best golfer in the world is on PGA Tour's name, Scottie Scheffler.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And is Scottie Scheffler good for golf? He's very boring.
He's a very boring.
Very boring guy.
So was Spieth.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just – Oberg is
Spieth
too.
Spieth had a flair for the dramatic, though.
Yeah, yeah.
And
Scheffler just dominates.
Scheffler's so good, he doesn't have any dramatic.
Doesn't need it.
Yeah. He just hits it close.
His dramatic is the tournament every now and then where he misses a putt to tie for the lead on the 18th hole.
Yeah.
That's his drama. He's done that two or three times. Other than that, he's beaten you by four.
Yeah. So is he? He's just a boring dude, man. But you know what? Maybe that's a good thing for the PGA Tour right now as it goes forward and with everything else flying around it as they try to figure things out in an ultimate whatever they're going to do, merger
or
whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, I could care less. I know which golf I'll be watching every weekend. And, you know.
I wonder, do the LIV guys, as they come through, like, and they get to be a part of it again for just this week, does it, like, and they go back to their world. I mean,
does it stoke their competitive fire?
And how they feel.
It's got to be more fun.
This kind of sucks.
They're trying to win money on LIV Tour. I mean, they are. But, again, if according to the bylaws as they were written, and we know, all they're doing is winning back the money they've already been paid.
Yeah, it's just
so it's like whatever. And if you don't win it back, you keep it anyway.
54 holes, in our shorts.
Whatever. And if y'all want to, that's fine. But don't tell me it's competition, man. Yeah. Anyway, I'm so tired of that whole argument.
And Koepka probably will make a zing back along the way. You never know with him.
Maybe.
Or maybe he's just disinterested. I don't know. But anyway, it was interesting. And we'll talk more about the Masters throughout as we get ready for the Guggen. I have one more dream. Today's Dream Finders.
Coastal Equipment Guggen Open, we should be saying as well. Thanks. So pleased to be back as our title sponsor.
Yes.
And, perhaps they're the ones that will be liable for the damages when the Guggen Nation takes over this place here in a couple hours.
Oh, I can't wait. So our current Dream Finders poll question of the day, and again, 20-plus locations in Jacksonville to serve you. Visit DreamFindersHomes.com for all your information. After watching the Orange and Blue game this weekend, how do you handle, what are your thoughts on the quarterback situation? You play Mertz, give DJ a series or two. If DJ's better, he starts. You ride or die with Mertz, or you simply just don't let DJ get to the portal.
It's A. A or four. Mertz is better.
Yeah.
I mean, much better option. And what it means, though, is if you don't have Mertz for a quarter or a game or 3 weeks, it's not game over, season over. That's what I took from watching those two dudes the other day. And Lagway is his advertised, Hick. He's poised. You know what I liked about him? You know, here he is in his first game out there, a lot going on. It seemed like the play clock was never at three. You know, he got up, he got guys ready, and he played well. But Mertz played just as good or better than he did. And he's mature and established. And so
leader of the team.
He's the leader of the team. And I do think that Napier is right
about ceiling's higher for Lagway.
For sure. And,
way
and it's a, but it's a good situation for Lagway to be. And Lagway, by the way, there is no – I saw Lagway's dad tweeted out to Mertz, thank you for the way you've treated our son and being the – you know, the welcoming him and teaching him. And so I think Lagway is mature enough to know – that okay, I'm gonna learn as best I can. It'll be all his ship the following year, and that might be enough to get things going in the right direction, right? If anything's gonna do it, it will be a difference making quarterback. And Trey Wilson is just even better than he was, Nick. A little heavier.
And so the big question though going forward, because we all know how difficult it's gonna be this year for Florida football and how they have to kind of figure their way out and how there's pressure. But does Lagway give Napier any kind of not leverage, but
I think they just need to win more games.
Does it buy him time? Does it, you know, listen.
Maybe.
If it goes bad,
yeah,
it's not good for the program to change coaches. But,
if you lose the coach and the quarterback, though, then we're just sitting at 5-7 again.
I know Gator Nation, and if it's 23-20 Miami week one, it's, you know, and there's 10 guys on the field for – I mean, there was a play, I guess, where there was 12 guys on the field for a
– 10.
PAT.
This week, 10. It was 10, not 12.
And they all
still
jump.
A mistake.
They all jump on it.
Yeah.
You know? Man, look,
I thought
8
million
people.
I'll just say this. From watching every minute of every Gator football game last year and watching every minute of the Orange and Blue game this year, they are better than they were last year.
They're
more talented. Now, they need to be a lot better and a lot more talented. That's the point. Now, they're not even competitive with Georgia, Dan. They're not even competitive. And that ultimately is where you got to get.
Yeah.
When Florida was dominating, right, Georgia would still come in. They would just lose a heartbreaker.
Yeah.
Like, Florida can't even play with them. So Billy Napier is so far behind that the problem is how much progress is enough.
Right.
I saw Spurrier picking him 8-4, but I don't know if you know what that means.
He's a Gator. All right, we're just warming up, man. We got to have a good day. It's going to be warm out here. It's going
to
be beautiful.
Who you got coming out here to the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open?
My friends from ITP Partners.
Okay, nice.
And, my
client support
there. One of my buddies. So we'll crank it up here today and get after it. And
I'll be playing with the legend and then a couple of legends from Live Forever Golf, Matt Avery. I decided I'm going to throw a PGA Tour. If you guys want to go kart golf today, we'll bet you. I got Maddie. and then the president over there, Live Forever Golf, too. So looking forward to hanging out with them. It's a fun day. Is 10 going to come by at all?
No, 10 couldn't make it.
Oh.
10 is
I thought he was going to come by even though he wasn't going to golf.
Oh, I don't know. This is the first time maybe ever or maybe one other one where 10 missed, but he has a flight out of here. At last check, he had a flight out of here early, so he would only get to play like three or
four.
Well,
it's disappointing because it had become a tradition here that about, you know, 9:30, 10 would throw me a – well, let's just say someone would say crown and seven. I won't explain to the little Googans out there what that means.
Yes.
And so, yeah, it'll be tough to not get that, Gibby. You feel me on that one, right? So, anyway.
Gibby likes to get into the hooch.
Yeah, he does. Mm-hmm. He's been into it already this morning.
I believe.
Yeah,
just what do you think's in here?
A raging drunk, you know, is what he is, and that's fine, mm-hmm. you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. As long as he doesn't drive.
Driving a big 10-10 bus, so no, yeah, that's right. A no.
Oh, yeah, it's a hard no.
Boy, yeah. hard no. All right, so we got a lot going up. It's going to be a fun day here. The sun is rising, and away we go.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards. Get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508 or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781. Subject to lender approval. Equal housing lender.
Break free from the old school hassle at All Pro Roofing. They've revolutionized the game. And guess what? No more pressure, hassle, or time meeting with someone face-to-face for a roof quote. Unlock the power of an instant roof quote right from the comfort of your home. Get the information you need when you need it. Explore your roofing options today. Head over to allproroofingllc.com. Hit that instant roof quote tab for a free instant roof quote. Allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060138.
You see this smile on my face? I got a smile on my face all the time because I'm so happy that I've joined the George Moore Chevrolet family. When I say family, I mean it, man. That's how they treat you when you head over to that beautiful showroom off Atlantic Boulevard and find out exactly what I'm talking about. No pressure, just friendly help. That smile on my face means I walk out to my beautiful blue Silverado. You're my boy, Blue! I'm cruising around town, and I love it. Whether you want a car, a truck, SUV, electric, pre-owned, George Moore Chevrolet has it. If you can't make it over to Atlantic Boulevard, don't worry. MoreChevy.com. Easy to navigate as any site you'll try. All the vehicles, transparent pricing. It's right there for you. Sales and service to parts. Never been more easy to use. That's MoreChevy, M-O-O-R-E, Chevy.com. George Moore Chevrolet. Together, let's drive.
Hey, I know we love our happy hours, but have you been to Mr. Chubby's Wings for lunch lately?
Yep, their new specials are awesome. I eat lunch there all the time.
I went this week and got wings, a drink, and chips for $8.
As usual, the best prices in town. You can't hardly find anyone doing $8 lunch anymore.
I know. I'm saving my money for the weekends with $8 lunch specials.
Save your money for the weekends. Enjoy $8 lunch specials Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Three locations serving you for all sports all year. Mr. Chubby's Wings, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. Spring is here, and that means your to-do list just got longer. But don't stress, everyone. The good folks at Fenwick Home Services have you covered 24/7 with cooling and plumbing solutions to fit any budget. From minor upgrades to major repairs, whatever problem you're staring down, the pros at Fenwick get it done and get it done right the first time. Spring is also a great time to schedule your AC tune-up to avoid costly breakdowns. Fenwick certified technicians will inspect your system to make sure it runs efficiently and remove buildup and dust, pollen and dander so you can breathe easier. Book now at FenwickHomeServices.com/radio.
For the greenest, luscious lawn on the block, choose the local legends, Roundtree Sod. Don't just settle for ordinary. Let Roundtree Sod deliver you a picture-perfect lawn. To get a free estimate, call 7414-SOD. 7414-SOD.
This is 1010XL, 92.5 FM.
Now that's what I call high-quality H2O.
If you want high-quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. WaterboyJAX.com.
Have you or someone you care about been arrested or had their driver's license taken away? I'm Susan Cohen, and I work with David Robbins at the law firm of Epstein & Robbins. We are experienced fighters for those charged with DUI and all criminal offenses. I've been named the best DUI attorney in the state, and David has been named the best criminal defense lawyer in Jacksonville. In your battle with the justice system, there is only one thing you need to know. Dial David 24/7 at Epstein & Robbins, 354-5645.
Hey, Hicken here, or just call me Danny Dreamfinders. For a limited time, on select move-in ready homes, Dreamfinders Homes is offering an amazing 3.99% interest rate in year one of your mortgage. Now is your chance to lock down the rate. You heard me right. 3.99% offer in year one. Visit DreamfindersHomes.com for sales event information and get the game. Interest rate available on select move-in ready homes. Restrictions and limitations apply. Go to DreamfindersHomes.com for more details.
For lost or broken keys or nearly any make and model of vehicle, call 722-1111 for
Instant Keys.
Instant Keys.
You don't have to go to the dealer. Instant Keys comes to you.
Attention poker enthusiasts, get ready for unbeatable action at Best Bet with locations in Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine. On April 19th and 20th, dive into the excitement with $1,500 high hands every 30 minutes. And save the date for April 27th, because it's 24-karat gold day at Best Bet Jacksonville, where we're dealing out $24,000 in prizes throughout the day, starting at 10 a.m. Want in on the action? Visit BestBetJax.com for all the details. That's BestBetJax.com.
It's back, the biggest jewelry sale of the year. Buy one, get one at Beard's Diamonds.
No other jewelry store in North Florida can match it. Buy any band and get the other one free.
The whole month of April.
Beard's Diamonds will beat any competitor's price.
At the St. John's Town Center.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Now, the 10-Minute Drill.
This is a big one.
On 1010XL.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Hit it.
Yeah. Okay. All right, sports concepts and rationalizations. We call it the 10-Minute Drill. At the end of the drill, we like to hand out what E likes to call razzle dazzle. E, what are you going to dazzle us with this AM?
Oh, snap. Happening this Saturday. I got a pair of tickets to the annual Guns N' Hoses fight night at UNF, Saturday, April 20th. All you got to do is holler at your boy.
All right, so that'll be at the end of the drill. 641-1010 is the number to call. There was a...
I made a terrible mistake.
Hot. What's that?
I've got on a pair of socks that the back of them, the heels, want to ride down.
Oh, I know that
feeling.
You
know what I'm talking about? Y'all know what I'm saying. When you get them on a pair of socks and they want to ride down too hard. I mean, these are like foot joy, dry joys. This shouldn't be happening, Hick.
Right.
You have better...
That's a problem.
You know, because it goes down just a little bit more. That's correct.
Or
you got to keep doing this all day, right? You know, no one wants
all
to do
day,
that.
All day,
so it's first world problems. I'm not going to deny, still.
No one wants to do that.
You feel me?
I feel you, man.
No one wants to do that. There was a hot little rumor yesterday that, gosh, it's been talked about forever, and then it was debunked by said agent of player that Brandon Ayuk had officially requested a trade, and it was talking about teams that were interested in whatever. It will be interesting to see going forward what the Jaguars ultimately decide to do if they move up. But it does seem like receiver is a position of need for this football team. And whether it be Ayuk or going up to get Odunze or Neighbors or whomever. Or
it's going to be Thomas or A.D. Mitchell, I bet you.
Or staying put and taking one of those guys. The Jags do seem poised to try to find themselves – a receiver.
Steve Smith break down Thomas's like a highlight tape. I'm starting to like him a little bit more, man.
Oh, he's got some skills.
Yeah, he got some juice.
I think for the Jacks to be successful, they need to hit with a receiver at 17 rather than trade for Ayuk or Higgins, I think, because gives them the ability to find a guy, you know, less expensive. They got Trevor they're going to have to deal. We haven't gotten into other guys you would, you know, potentially like to keep.
Yeah.
Like to keep ETN, like to keep Tyson Campbell. I'd like to be able to keep these guys, right? I mean, we don't have 50 of them, and I'm not saying they're all highly paid, but if you can get the same production, I mean, if you're comping Thomas as T. Higgins,
Yeah.
You know, let's get Thomas for, you know, this amount of million and not Higgins for 18.
I agree, but I also don't think there are a ton of players that the Jaguars have to keep.
No, I'm not saying that they have to, but I'm just, you know.
I mean, running backs, they use them up, they pitch them out.
Not us. Ours are terrible.
Yeah.
If we didn't have VTN's not running, who is? Somebody you don't want running.
The next guy.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to find him. I mean,
well, for sure. We haven't, though. It's two drafts in a row. Although, let's see if we can get something. Let's see if some onboarding took place, Hick. Maybe guys in the second year will be ready. Right?
Maybe.
You know,
hopefully. Onboarding. But, yeah, so anyway, that's kind of this is pre-draft week, and so there's the scheduled, you know, luncheons and opportunities to talk to a few players as, you know, the off-season conditioning program phase whatever begins, and away we go with the 2024 season. You have to kind of put – it's so funny. Like, every season you go back to zero. I can remember – shoot, I remember Doug Marrone saying after the great run of 17, well, we're back to zero, and it didn't work. But so when you're good, you start over, and when you're bad, you start over. It doesn't matter either way. You're still starting over, and that's what happens, and that's what will occur with this Jaguar football team as we get ready for this 2024 football season, the 30th year of our Jacksonville Jaguars. Wow. 30th year, still no Super Bowl appearance. Feel free to change that for us.
Yeah, the Lions and Browns said that, cry me a river.
Yeah.
But still, to not even go to one is pretty weak. The Panthers have been to a few.
Stumble into one.
I mean, the Falcons, the Bucks, all the bad teams have been to them except for the Browns and the Lions and us.
Oof.
Now, also the Texans, but they're new to the party.
Well, for the first time in a long time, I was paying attention to a lot of NBA yesterday, a lot of seeding going on and positioning going forward and guys sitting out. You know what we do in New York? We're like Tom Coughlin's Giants. We play to win. That's what we do. We line up. We play to win. We don't sit people.
Why would you not want to win? I never understood the argument.
Well, you might be better off not playing Philly or Miami. You might be better off with Indiana.
I think Indiana. I'd rather play Philly or Miami than Indiana.
Well, we play to win around here or you know,
I mean, settle down their Golden State DNA.
So we
have. Relax
a little bit. It's all the DNA, Jeff. That's what you tell me.
Come on, man.
We were going for our 50th win yesterday. And kudos to the Bulls. They played hard, man.
They're going to kill us.
I hate that Caruso guy.
They're going to kill us so bad. Oh, the Hawks are going to get beat by 40.
Hawks decided to take.
The Hawks are terrible.
Hawks play too, but they just don't play defense. They play half the court, half the game. When they bring the ball down the court, they try. But when they go back, they just say, go ahead and score.
Fun fact. The play-in experiment is dumb. Okay, I'm trying not to use the word dumb. I don't like the play-in at all. It's not proving anything. There's nothing. It's never going to produce any kind of anything. It's
Didn't
a waste
it
of time.
Did produce the Heat from the play-in?
The Heat were the 7th seed. They were in the play. They were in
they were in the play-in.
They were in the dumb play-in.
Yeah.
But they didn't need to be. 9-10.
Didn't you beat the Heat in the first game?
Yeah, and then they went in. Okay, so they were the 8. My point is, over the 82, they qualified for the playoffs.
Yeah.
That's my point.
You know, 9-10.
Yes. Yeah. All you do in 9-10 is this, Dan. The Bulls are going to beat the Hawks, and then you're going to tell either you're going to tell the Sixers, hey, here's another game Embiid can get hurt. Or are you going to tell the Heat, hey, here's another game Jimmy Butler can get hurt.
You
play 82 to get 1-8. Just let 1-8 in. You got your in-season tournament now. You've maxed your revenue. The play-in is just not.
I don't need it. I don't care.
The teams are terrible.
Yeah.
And out west, here's the counter-argument. Well, you got Golden State, Sacramento. Well, that's great. Without a play-in, maybe we could have seen them play good championship ball down the stretch.
Well, they would have played
because it would have mattered.
Yeah. So the Lakers got a kind of a bad draw because they get New Orleans, who they'll beat, but then they get the Nuggets.
Oh, they do? If they're the 7, though.
Yeah. Well, if they.
Oh, yeah.
I think when they beat New Orleans, they'll be the 7.
You might be better off just losing New Orleans and trying to win the next football. You can't do anything like that. They'd be better off as an 8. I'd rather face Oklahoma City, who hasn't, you know, they've gone from no playoffs to the number 1 seed. Man, you want to talk about a good GM?
Yeah.
Whoever's running that show, this team had the number 1 picks here. They were terrible, and now they're best record in the league, in a tough league.
Yeah.
The East is just dog do. Ugh.
Yeah, I don't agree.
Okay.
I tell you, Joe Yu annoyed me on Twitter yesterday, and this is from the dumbness of Joe Yu. And again, people know that he's dumb. So, but on a day where the Pelicans get trashed, and I just put out a tweet that, hey, look at the Knicks playing, fighting for the number 2 seed, blah, 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 blah. for you to come back with the East is trash and the Pels would be a two seed, it's probably not a good day to go saying that when they're getting beat by 30 at home by Lakers.
Yeah.
I mean, so what are you talking about?
Two things can be true. The East can be weak, but don't put the Pelicans into the strength category of NBA hoops.
Yes.
Yeah. I tried to put them there, and then they decided to go backwards.
Yeah, so anyway, Lakers-Nuggets would be an intriguing series. I assume the Nuggets would win that, but we shall see. AD and LeBron are full go. They'll battle. The Lakers will battle. But anyway, so the NBA playoffs are set. The NHL playoffs will be set. Their season ends Thursday, but my gosh, you know, you talk about a meaningless, important game for the New York Hockey Rangers.
That's, a meaningless, important game.
Yeah, that's tonight in the big scheme. They've clinched playoff a long time ago. They're one win away from the President's Trophy and sewing up the division. But if they lose and Carolina wins, they would lose President's Trophy and division. I mean, and here they are with – the most wins in franchise history, but they never shook Carolina the whole year. So, you know, they got a game tonight against Ottawa.
Yeah, I don't like being the one. Like, it's like of all the craziness that happens in tournament sports, the eight beating the one in hockey seems to be the one that's kind of like it's like the 12-5 thing was in NCAA hoops. So
still like
I think I'd rather be two and play seven.
There's still like three, four teams, the Red Wings and the Penguins and the Caps and the Flyers all trying to get that last spot to play the Rangers if the Rangers win.
Hockey probably is the most parity, isn't it? Like the number one, the crazy steamrolling team doesn't seem to win in hockey.
Our Iceman took it on the chin yesterday.
What?
Yeah, so we ended up a two seed. So we'll start the playoffs Thursday against the Dadgum Everblades, which is a showdown of epic proportions. The Everblades are the two-time Kelly Cup champions, and they've knocked us out, I think, the last 2 years. We must take the skate
I like the prep work you've just given me.
To the Everblades starting Thursday. I believe that one is at home. It's just like the NHL, 16. We ended up second, 1 point out. But, yeah, we lost a tough one yesterday. We got gave up far too many goals. I think it was 7-4 final. I think it was Atlanta matched us goal for goal. We took the early lead, and then they just stayed with us, and they got us at the end. So, anyway, we'll see how it all plays out. But, yeah, the Icemen, it's hard to complain. They've had an unbelievable year, great season. But they did not win the division. They ended up 1 point shy, I think, of I forget who it is, Greenville or whomever. But I know we play the Everblades, which is, you know, the Everblades are good. So are we. So we owe them. So hopefully it'll be a little revenge factor coming
up. Got some highs and lows from Major League Baseball. Where would Doc Gooden rank on the list of best pitchers that you've seen?
Top five.
He's so much better. My point, I agree, and I think you've echoed my point. I think because of all the off-field drama and problems people don't remember how great Doc Gooden was.
It was more like a season, though. It was a season where he was great.
Was 24-4 or something like that?
24-4, 1.5 ERA, 16 complete games, 8 shutouts. I mean, he was –
that was it, though?
Well, it wasn't it. The next year he was 17-9, though, which is a far cry from 24-4.
And the guys were just into the coke up there, too, now, right?
Him and the straw. Yeah, so that was white powder. Yeah.
You know, don't do drugs, kids. It'll – you know. Is Doc Gooden in the Hall of Fame? No.
No.
Is Strawberry in the Hall of Fame?
No. No.
Neither will be?
No. No.
But
it was a nice ceremony.
Doc
looked
a little rough yesterday, too. I'm not going to lie.
Doc has looked rough for years.
Yeah.
Doc has battled demons, man. So I was happy. And he talked about it. He tried to get back with the Mets like 5, 6, 7 times, and he finally got back with them yesterday to retire. But it was
194 and 112, 3.51 ERA.
You know, those are good numbers. Don't get me wrong. But this kid – when he burst onto the scene as rookie of the year, and then the 24-4, and then he went 17-9 the following.
Actually, he went 17-9, and then went 24-4, and then went 17-6.
17-6. Okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, 17-9 was his rookie of the year. Then 24-4. Then he went 17-6, which is you
and
know.
Then he went 15-7. Then he went 18-9, and then he got injured. Went 9-4. Then went 19-7.
Yeah.
So I mean, he's averaging close to 20 wins for those first.
Yeah.
5 or 6, and then 13 and 7, and then, I don't know, arm issues, 10 and 13, 12 and 13, 3 and 4? Then went to the Yankees. And
he won a World Series with the Yankees.
Yeah, but won 11 games 1 year there, but the ERA was over 5.
Yeah.
Just kind of, yeah, you're right. I would have remembered him as, I guess I just have that 1985 season. That's the one that I was 4th of July at the at the stadium.
So
I don't
good.
Think he was the starter that night. I think it was Sid Fernandez.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I can just remember him dominating the league. 85, what'd y'all do? Is that the year that Hershiser beat you?
No, that was 88.
88.
We came on. 85 is when we kind
is
of
that Cardinals?
Yeah, we sort of established ourselves, but we didn't win the division, but established ourselves as a good young team. Then 86 we exploded. Then 87 and 88 we were – 88 was the one that
haunted. Other Major League Baseball.
Damn
news.
You, T-Bone Shelby. Damn
really,
you.
Really, really, really sad to see Bryce Harper off to a 1-11 start. He's got like you know 4 hits all year, and also glad to see that the trillionaire out there in Los Angeles is now a singles hitter. So good that Freddie Freeman's got a grand total of 4 extra base hits now, about 20 some odd games into the year. I hate those Dodgers, and what a nice little comeuppance yesterday for Mr. Irrelevant. You know, who are you, Will Smith? By the way, when did somebody name you a Hall of Fame all-time catcher? Shut your mouth. That little dust-up Saturday night, and it involved Jackson Profar, or Jerks and Profar.
Yeah, he's a pain in the
ass.
And
he is, but you want him on your team, but you don't call
ass.
It. But he's not
yeah.
irrelevant,
no.
okay?
No.
And so after the game, they ask Will Smith, the Dodgers game. Well, I don't really talk about it. I don't know why. He's not really relevant. And then he had the game-winning hit yesterday, so there's your relevance.
But that adds to the
Profar
rivalry.
Is that guy. I get you. We've all had him on our team from time to time. The A's are a game back in the West. Explain that one.
They started so poorly,
yeah.
and they've caught fire. Give the skipper credit. I mean, I don't know how – yeah. It's so.
They'll probably get good in just time for Sacramento to enjoy them, Dan.
Sacto.
The Chicago White Sox are off to a historically bad start. They're like 2-13, I think.
Yeah.
Which, like, is among the worst starts in all of Major League Baseball in years. So, that's not good. And don't look now. I don't know how this is possible, but so far the best division in baseball. You want to take a guess? Do you know? Do you know the best division in baseball?
I will guess it's the AL Central.
That's a good guess, except for the
NL
fact
Central.
That – yeah, it's the NL Central because I just told you that the White Sox are so terrible. The NL Central is got the two biggest surprises probably in baseball with the Brewers and the Pirates.
Yeah.
They have two more teams that are over 500, and their fifth team is –
we got the Bucks coming into City this week, and then we're off to – the West Coast.
Well, we just went through the, quote, easy part of our schedule, a sterling 3-3 versus the Mets and Marlins, and quite frankly, happy to be there after it took Ozuna on an 0-2 pitch, hitting a 3-run homer in the ninth to escape Miami with 2 out of 3. The Braves' pitching has been pedestrian to this point, but again, I'm not going to quibble at 9-5. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, that's all you can do.
Well, now the schedule gets hard is my point. We go to Houston, although maybe that's not hard anymore.
All right, a lot going on. We got to move ahead. 641-1010 is the number to call. As we head to break, we're live at the Guggen. It's the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. We're excited to be here out of Hidden Hills. Appreciate them having us again. Course is in great shape. We're ready to rock and roll. Tell them what they're going to win.
A pair of tickets to the annual Guns N' Hoses Fight Night that's happening at UNF Arena this Saturday, April 20th. All you got to do is holler at your boy.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Jacksonville's one of a kind.
I heard a story about you. I was wondering if it's true.
Everything you've heard about me is true.
This is 1010XL.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got 2 great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
Here's Linda Beaver.
Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet have just received a special allocation of new vehicles directly from the factory. Not 10, not 20, but hundreds of new vehicles with special savings that haven't been seen in years. Every new vehicle available in your favorite color and option as far as the eye can see. Plus, get our exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty with every new car purchase. Hurry to Beaver Toyota in St. Augustine or Beaver Chevrolet in Jacksonville before the best deals are gone.
At Andy's Automotive and Truck Services, they know that your company's fleet is more than just a bunch of cars and trucks. It's your livelihood, your reputation, your pride. So when you need routine fleet maintenance or emergency repairs, Andy's offers after-hours and mobile service to minimize your downtime and keep your fleet running like new. While you care for your employees and customers, rest assured Andy's Automotive will take care of your fleet. Visit the team at andysats.com.
Hey, Hicken here. You know I'm a hometown guy. Nothing like home in Jacksonville, Florida. Great place to live. Spring's here. Everything's green and blooming. Also means we need to do some deep cleaning inside the house. And gang, that's where Zero Res comes in. Zero Res will clean your tile, your grout, your carpets, your area rugs, your furniture, and more. Right now, offer 25% off tile and grout cleaning. Zero Res. You spell it forward. Zero Res, you spell it backwards. It's the right way to clean.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contracting. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Hicken here, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, about nigh can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit aboutnigh.com to schedule your consultation. About nigh and Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
I'm Hacker. Get more Gators on the Gator Bites podcast presented by Southeast Orthopedic Specialist with new episodes every Wednesday. Subscribe and listen by searching for 1010XL Florida Gator Podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, or TuneIn.
Big Brothers Big Sisters is teaming up with the NFL to inspire change. From now to draft day, Big Brothers Big Sisters is following the NFL draft, aiming to recruit potential bigs. Hi, I'm Brent from the 1010 sales team. I'm committed as a mentor, and we need you to step up and become a mentor too. There's a waiting list of more than 50 children hoping for a mentor. It's just a few hours a month. Be a mentor. Become a big. Visit bbbsnefl.org. Be a mentor or visit Big Brothers Big Sisters and click on Big Draft.
Hey, Scarline here. Tired of missing out on the conversation due to hearing loss? At Jacksonville Hearing and Balance, their team of audiologists led by Dr. Douglas Green can help you rediscover the joy of connection. Visit jhbi.org today.
Everybody, Mike Dempsey here for Dandy Foods. Dandy subs and sandwiches, look, we always want you to think about those great options as you're driving around Duval. But the beauty is, even as I'm dropping pounds, Dandy's got great options for me as well. Told you all about their protein packs, delicious salads that they have out there. They have fruit cups for on the go. You know what they have, veggie snack trays. You can grab those on the go as well. Perfect healthy snack. Dandy is the name to know when you're on the go. So stop into a Gate store anywhere around Duval and make yours a Dandy and do it today.
AgPro Sign and Drive event is offering 0% for 84 months with no money down on a John Deere compact utility tractor with loader. Limited time offer. Visit your local AgPro dealership today. Offer ends 4/30/24. Subject to approved credit. See dealer for details.
Slacker Palmin.
Yeah, hey, listen, I need a plumber over here right now.
Yeah, well, we don't have any openings for about 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yep.
I was just changing the shower head, and the water line broke, and it's flying everywhere.
All right, 1 week.
What if I throw you an extra $100 to come now?
What's the address?
It's 205.
Huh? I guess he changed his mind.
If you've got a leak that can't wait a week, call Roland Reese Plumbing and fix your plumbing problems fast. PlumbingJacksonville.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
sometimes you got to go to the event if you want to see the whole event. That's the way it works, Peep. Sorry, you can't expect. You
poor.
Can't get mad at TV.
Yeah,
I mean, we got
poor.
Things to do at 11 o'clock. We got local news to get to.
Yeah, that's poor. Yeah. Oof. So last night, Billy Joel's giving some concert in the park or whatnot.
No, it's his 100th live at Madison Square Garden.
All right, so he's live at MSG. It's being televised by CBS. They get to straight up 11 o'clock in the middle of Piano Man, and it's boom, we're off to local news.
Yeah, I guess the whole – I don't know what happened with the East Coast and Central time zones. They dumped out of it, and I'm sure there's a reason why. I don't know if it, like, automatically did it. It was going to be over at 11. I don't know the backstory behind it.
I don't, maybe finish the song. I'm just
saying. It was – well, I mean, again, there's not – you can't – like, each station does – it.
Well, they do for sports.
Again, they're all on the same page. It automatically does it. It's not, you don't have Dick's not sitting there going, oh, stand by 10:59.
No, 59.
You're missing
my point.
Click.
CBS hands it over to you like they do after a live sporting event. That's what I'm saying. Get to the end and then hand it to them.
So then CBS made that decision if that's the way it was done.
Yeah,
100%. Not the locals.
No, so. Not every single local at the same time would have dumped out.
Right.
I'm not saying that's what happened.
So I'm saying each station doesn't have a guy. It's got to be done.
Right. CBS does it. CBS screwed up. That's who I'm saying. I'm not saying the locals screwed it up.
But
CBS screwed it up.
If you hadn't, it was a great, I mean, it's such a, I mean, seeing it on TV, you know, because we went to him, see him in October. We had always wanted to see Billy, or I had always wanted to see, and Reagan came along, wanted to see Billy Joel at the Garden, and TV did it justice. It was a great. Yeah. It was great on television.
It was just ironic in the middle of Piano Man, his most famous song.
Oh, well, that's the end of the show.
Yeah, I mean, come on. Ride it out a minute, CBS. I mean, you make us sit around for like the conclusion of some PGA golf tournament or a regular season. Mm-hmm. You know,
I wonder if that was a curtain
college
call.
Basketball game.
He left, and I wonder if that was a curtain call.
Yeah, right. I wasn't watching.
Wouldn't that would have been even worse.
Yeah, I wouldn't be shocked if it was. It probably was, but I don't know. Like I said, I was. Well, we were doing the shows at the time, so
you know how you talk about media day photos, like a media guide photo, like if your team, if Citadel's playing at Florida or mm-hmm. Citadel's playing at Georgia, and they take a 3-0 lead, you go ahead and take that picture, and it goes in the media guide the next day.
It's on the cover,
yeah. Mark Pope got his media guide photo yesterday. Okay, let me go ahead and give you my fearless prediction. All right.
This is a good one because I'll counter that a little bit.
All right. My fearless prediction is this, that when Mark Pope walked out into a sold-out Rupp Arena yesterday, if they brought him in with a bus carrying a national title he helped to win back in 1996 and looked up at the adoring fans and all the hoopla and the glory of Kentucky basketball, mm-hmm. that was the highlight of his Kentucky coaching career.
I don't know. And we'll see.
You got too much Kentucky in your ear, Hick. I mean, let me tell you. Let me look at it from an objective standpoint.
You're looking at it from not objective. You're looking at it from a detached. I will look at it from this standpoint. First off, for those of you who like to say that the Big Blue Nation is dead, there's not a program in this country that would be turning people away from a 24,000 seat arena on a Sunday afternoon to introduce their coach, Kentucky.
That's great if you're a Kentucky fan.
That was impressive. And the fact that they're embracing a guy who's replacing a guy who's much more well-known and still came out to support him is also very
good. Well, that's because they wanted
good.
Or they ran off the other guy. Well, and so there's extra juice. I mean, they could have named Dan Hicken the coach, and they probably would have been excited.
And the other thing is, and again, analytically speaking, this guy apparently has a great understanding and a fun offense and one that is very successful and is a real, like, X's and O's savant. So we'll see. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. You could be right. But what I've come to learn is that Big Blue Nation and the Kentucky Jeffs of the world and such have – embraced the hiring of Mark Pope.
Well,
so we'll see.
Gator Nation embraced the hiring of Billy Napier. How's that gone?
Yeah. Well, you eventually try to find some of the positives in the situation.
I'm not going by anything other than just his coaching record. I don't know his personality. I don't know mm-hmm. if the pressure of the job or the scope of the job. I don't know if any of those things matter. I just, I know that you're bringing in a guy mm-hmm. that you just fired a guy for having those kinds of results.
Oh, yeah. That's
the hard part.
But he steps in knowing the expectation, and I'm sure he's thinking, well, I'll have better players. If I have better players, I'll do better.
Yeah.
than I did at Brigham Young. So I don't know.
The hardest thing to believe about Mark Pope is he played 8 years in the NBA.
Yeah, Mark Pope was.
That's not even fair. A lot of years he played a game or four games or six games. He had 1 year where he played a bunch for the Milwaukee Bucks. He played 63 games in 2000, which has nothing to do with his head coaching record. He started at Utah Valley, Danny, with 77-56 there.
Mm-hmm.
Moved on to BYU, where he's been 110-52, so he's been a very good regular season coach, 679 winning percentage. NIT quarters and two losses in the first round of the NCAA tournament in his.
Was it 3 years?
And in fairness, he was there 5 years.
5 years.
And in fairness, one of the years there was no postseason. So he had him 24-8 and 13-3 in the league that year. So, yeah, look, they've got all the resources.
I'd say what Kentucky, though.
Recruits itself. I mean, you pick the right guys, you're going to have a roster.
They did it right. They did it right yesterday. Traipsed him off the bus with all his old teammates
sure,
who won a natty.
Yeah,
that was good. That was good stuff.
I imagine, didn't Reed Shepard's dad play with him? Wasn't Jeff Shepard on those teams Mark Pope?
Good question. That I do not know.
I was just sitting there one day, and I'm thinking, well, is this Reed Shepard? Is this Jeff Shepard's little brother or his cousin or something? I had no idea it was that long since Jeff Shepard was playing at Kentucky.
Yes, it is. So, anyway.
I'm going to go with that'll be the highlight of Mark Pope. Right. We'll see. We'll see how it goes from
there.
I need a little more sizzle to my steak if I'm going to hire a Kentucky coach.
Yeah. Well, look, he certainly wasn't the first choice, and he went down the list. And you know, sometimes you never know.
It does, in all seriousness, and I'm not – this isn't a criticism. It does feel – it's kind of like Billy Napier. It's the same kind of settle. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, the big names in the Division I, the FBS, you know, weren't there, and you settle for a guy who's been – very successful at a slightly lower level of hoops, and that's kind of what Pope was at BYU.
I was watching some of the Gator baseball game yesterday.
Did they end up winning a game at all this weekend?
They won yesterday.
Okay.
They stopped the bleeding.
Oof.
But they're
it's rough.
They're not going to – I don't know. I don't even know if they'll get in. They have a really tough schedule the rest of the way. I don't expect them to get into or be one of the top 64. I mean, it's going to be a challenge, man. They're going to have to win some baseball games. They're not done yet because of their strength of schedule, but they're going to have to play decent baseball, and they're not going to be hosting anything, that's for sure. So, and even yesterday, you know, Cags pitched well, hit a home run. It's all he does. But, you know, you get to the bullpen, and sure as heck, it went from 11-5 to 11-7 to 11-9 in the ninth. It got a little dicey there. If they get another guy on, I mean, they're battling again. They just, man, oh, man, they have just not pitched well at all this year. And I don't know what the answer is going to be, but they're 18-17 and 7-8 at the conference. They're very, very average now. Again, playing a very tough schedule. FSU's good. They beat Miami. They took care of I think they swept them.
Yeah, he's completely turned them around. I would expect FSU to –
They've got the right guy to lead the program, which I sort of expected. I was more surprised by their failures last year, but mm-hmm. he took a year to get his
it's,
way.
It's not
implemented.
Unlike Mike Norvell.
Yeah, well,
a slow start with Norvell and losing season, and you know you're wondering. And
but I think this guy who's a Seminole through and through will be there for the next 20 years, is what I think. But we'll see. And again, they're having an outstanding season.
All right, when we come back on the other side, as we broadcast live from the mm-hmm. Coastal Equipment Guggen Open here at Hidden Hills,
golfers yes.
start rolling in. The busy bees there of 1010XL staff are getting everything all set up for check-in. When we come back, I got a pest of the day, and I forget about it every year until it hits me in the face again. You may know where I'm going there. And Tom Brady has named the next quarterback he thinks will win his first Super Bowl.
Oh.
Yeah. Think about who that name may be and take a guess, and we'll fill
if it ain't Trevor, I ain't playing.
And we've got the Monday morning running back. Our weekly visit with Fred Taylor. That's coming up in the 8 o'clock hour. Matt Every will join us, a little Masters talk. He's going to be in my group today at the Guggen. I've decided we're going for broke this year. We're going to win it all. And then they told me that's not how it works. So I'll just have fun with Maddie. we'll talk a little bit of Masters with him, though. Jason Gibson and the Sharks are back home this weekend. He's on board here as we broadcast live from the Hidden Hills Golf and Country Club. You're listening to The Drill on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
The Drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
And now, the starting lineup.
The Drill Mornings. Jaguars.
starts today, 10 to noon. Helmets and Heels, noon to 2. XL Primetime, 2 to 4. The Franchi Show, 4 to 6. Into the Night with Rick Ballew and Hacker, After Dark. Evenings on 1010 XL.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Hacker here, and I'm loving the doors that are now opening now that I'm down almost 50 pounds. Oh yeah, and those results are in just 7 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. By doors, I mean opportunities I've avoided because of my weight, like an all-day adventure to SeaWorld or spending 3 days at Walt Disney World. Did I gain the normal 5 to 10 pounds I would have at Disney? Of course not. In fact, I lost 3 pounds last week at Disney, thanks to the good folks at Awaken 180. Awaken 180 travels with you, and I'm eating all sorts of foods, salmon, ground beef, broccoli, cabbage, collard greens, you name it. It's not a lie when I say I'm eating to lose weight is the only way to lose weight. Do what we all did, Matt, Mike, and myself. Call Awaken 180 Weight Loss, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or go online, awaken180weightloss.com.
Mia here. Looking to spruce up your home or business for the spring? Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate.
The flagship station of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Hey, I can hear from my friends at Lockhart Construction. Man, oh man, they're a longtime Jacksonville business. That means they do things right, they do things well. Shane's dad started the company, still with Shane. His guys are from here, taking care of people who live here, people like me. We've used Lockhart Construction not once, not twice, but 3 different times. We did one bathroom, we did another bathroom, we've done some remodeling. Shoot, if you want a new house, no job too big, no job too small. Give the Lockhart family a call. Their family gives your family a better living experience. I say you unlock better living with Lockhart Construction. So if you have a construction need, a simple question, a thought, an idea, give Shane a call. I call him all the time. Hey, Shane, can you do that? Yeah, I can do that. I said, okay, good. Hey, Shane, can you? Yeah, I got that. I said, okay, great. Shane will call you back. 994-3865. Shane Lockhart, Lockhart Construction. 994-3865.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit republicservices.com.
Equal opportunity. Employer.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Everbank Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official Duval draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick, and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by First Coast Honda Dealers. Gator football head coach Billy Napier saw plenty of growth in the team following the Orange and Blue game.
I see some guys that are in year two, year three of our systems that have played a lot of football, understand the expectations. They know what we expect of them as people, as students, as players.
Scotty Scheffler wins his second Masters in 3 years. The world's number one ranked player called the win special.
It's been a long week, a grind of a week. The golf course was so challenging.
challenging, and to be sitting here wearing this jacket again and getting to take it home is extremely special.
Florida baseball snapped a 6-game losing streak on Sunday with a win over the South Carolina Gamecocks. Every starter hit safely for Florida except for one. Next up, the Gators look to avenge a loss to Jacksonville University on Tuesday. That's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Sam Nelson.
Currently it's 8:08 and it's 62 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
Tone 10XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, back on the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com. Also, the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open, a tradition unlike any other, in a bad way. Looking forward to getting out here and having fun at the Hidden Hills Golf and Country Club today.
Screams tradition when you come out here. So many great memories. The Baselli-Ganey showdown on the putting green, the world-famous omelet maker that made two omelets before breaking one morning. The funny teeth.
Funny teeth was a
– Jack O'Brien gave out his first-place prize one year. Just
your famous exclamation about one of the men's products one year, and the guy happened to be sitting next to us. That was fun. Remember that one?
Whiskey Sunday out on the out on the course.
That was untoward. Some untoward things happened back in the old days.
Things got a little out of hand a few times. It's a great – tradition, and it's been going on now for quite some time. I don't know what year we're in.
We've gone all around the First Coast, and we've settled here at Hidden Hills the last few years, and Russ always loves to have us out here. It's nice to feel welcome and wanted, and so we're looking forward to having a good day today. And
no telling what will happen today.
Well, it's just a don't ask, don't tell. What happens in the hills stays in the hills. How about that?
That is true.
All right, it's time for today's Pest of the Day, brought to you by Mission Pest Solutions. Okay, you get solutions with Mission Pest Solutions. So call 944-PEST and tell them 1010XL sent you. You'll get 50% off your initial treatment. I was going to go with O.J. Simpson's estate, but this is right on brand with the Simpson name. And the family and the estate are going to be as heinous a personhood as their murderer father. And in this case, murderer absolutely applies because there was a civil judgment against O.J. Simpson, Dan. Mm-hmm. And somehow, you know, he didn't have the money to pay the Goldmans. And now that he's dead, guess what? There is money to pay the Goldmans, but O.J. Simpson estate is very quickly fighting against paying money from that wrongful death suit to the family after O.J. died from cancer. So I think that's just incredibly weak, whatever. But my pest of the day hits closer to home, Dan.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
My pest of the day is, I guess it's Major League Baseball.
Okay.
Again? I just don't know why in any form or fashion you want to exclude fans from watching your game if it is – otherwise available.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a glitch in the system, a glitch in the matrix, Hick, that when the Marlins play a home game,
oh yeah,
their broadcast partner is Florida Sports Network or whatever it's called, Bally Sports Florida, right? Mm-hmm. But they fall behind like the Magic and the Lightning in the priority order if there is a conflict.
Somebody didn't get to see the Bravos this weekend.
All three games, Dan. All three games. And here is my problem. If you want to do that, that's fine. But if I pay for extra innings, okay, you don't want me to watch the Braves broadcast because that's a competitor. I should be able to watch the Marlins broadcast on extra innings if the Marlins game is being blacked out on Bally's. That makes no sense. And I don't want to over-exaggerate, but I'd say from whatever part of the state where the Marlins are embargoed in favor of the Magic,
right?
I think you're leaving thousands of Braves fans on the, you know.
I'd be curious, I switched. I don't do extra innings anymore, so I went to MLB.com, and I wonder, I should have checked. You should have asked me to check yesterday. I'd be curious to see if I had the Braves.
I think they embargo it, Hick.
Marlins on that one or not. So that would be – and I'll have to wait and see. Now that Mets haven't played
– I mean, why stop there, Major League Baseball? Why not just, I don't know, embargo the score? Let everyone guess. I mean, you're not even allowed to follow the game.
Oh,
just take it a step further.
Oh, no.
I mean, we have the technology. The game is on the air. It's stupid 3 days in a row to not be able to watch the game. There's a hole there that Major League Baseball is messing up. And if you're a big enough fan that you – shell out for the extra innings, you ought to be able to watch every game.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Yeah. I would,
and it happens to you. I know it'll be the Mets later in the year, and you'll be complaining. You really need to play the Marlins in the middle of summer where nothing's going on.
Yeah, it's a good time. Yeah. It's a good time. It's all about the schedule makers. And Yeah, so I don't know. We had the Royals this weekend at home, so they were on all the time. So got a good dose of
– did you sweep them or two out of three?
Two out of three. We've won our series, three series in a row. Yeah. We're back to 7-8. We climbed out of the abyss. We're
beat us, hanging, I know that.
At least we're hanging in there.
Tom Brady has named
– who's he naming?
The quarterback
who
has not won a Super Bowl,
uh-huh.
who he thinks will be next to win it.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Brady, one of 34 starting quarterbacks who've won a Super Bowl.
Okay.
He's the only quarterback with 7 rings. Probably will probably keep that title, that claim for life. So, who do you think he picked?
That's a good question.
Now, just so you know, I mean, obviously, you got all those newcomers this year,
mm-hmm.
right? Jordan Love and Stroud.
Mm-hmm.
You got Justin Herbert, Joe Burrow, Trevor Lawrence, Tua Tagovailoa, Lamar Jackson, Josh Allen. You know, there's a ton of guys there. Where do you think Brady? And I guess what Brady is saying here is he thinks this is, you know, in golf, it's the best to never win a major.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I guess this is Brady telling us who's the best quarterback never to win a Super Bowl. No, is there any other way to define this? And by the way, in the guy that he picks, I think it would support that argument even more. So
I have a guess.
Okay.
I have a guess. I'm ready to announce my guess. I've been thinking about it, doing some research since the break, since the tease. And I've come up on one name, and I wish it was Trevor. It's not Trevor yet. I'm going to go with Joe Burrow.
Joe Burrow is a great guess. That would be mine. And if I had to name the guy that I think will be the next to win his first Super Bowl, I would say Joe Burrow. It's not Joe Burrow. Second guess, please.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's
not
what I was
Joe
thinking
Burrow.
As well. Joe Burrow.
Yeah. That's kind of the easy answer, I think. I mean, if he's healthy and he's proven how deep he can go,
I'm thinking of guys that he likes to throw, but he has respect for. I'll go next up. I'll go with Josh Allen.
He's gone Josh Allen.
Okay.
Here's why that surprised me.
Mm-hmm.
This isn't the trendy time to go, Josh Allen.
No.
Does anyone think the Bills are winning the Super Bowl this year with what they've lost?
Nope.
No.
So it better not be Lamar or Burrow or Herbert or Tua or Trevor or Stroud or Love or Goff. I mean, there's a bunch of guys there that are leading good teams that are pretty good quarterbacks, and I just wonder if the Bills don't take at least 1 year to kind of get back on track. Buffalo will be looking for a receiver on draft day, I'm sure.
Josh Allen is a Hall of Fame quarterback.
He's a difference maker.
And he is a guy who gives them a chance every year. And when they're struggling early, he led them to, what, six,
he's
seven
top three.
Wins
he,
in a row?
He's top three, right?
Yeah.
Isn't it Mahomes and then Allen? Well, if you could have anybody in the league, isn't it Allen?
I think so.
And he's a good leader. That's what Brady said, too. You know,
yeah.
He's a good leader. He can also, if he has to, beat you with his physicality.
Yes.
That's a good snag. I put him down the list a little bit only because I know all that Buffalo has lost this year. It doesn't seem like they're going to be any sort of Super Bowl favorite for sure in 2024. But
Truth of the matter is
Mahomes will win another one this year and Brady will still be right or still have it in play.
Yeah. Allen's end of the game against Kansas City still bothers me, man. He had guys running open and he didn't throw to. I don't know what – and then they settled on that missed field goal. It's annoying. It still bothers me.
Yeah.
It still bothers me the way that they played that thing out, and it happens because they put themselves in that position, but he is certainly talented enough, and you think at some point he will kick down the door and find himself a Super Bowl ring, but – how about getting to the Super Bowl? How about getting to an AFC Championship game? Something along those lines would be beneficial for Buffalo, because don't waste Josh Allen, Buffalo fan. Don't waste him. And I'm sure that's what they're thinking as he look, he's still a young guy, but, you know, they've had opportunities. They've knocked on the door, but they haven't kicked it in yet. Maybe this will be the year. Who knows?
Seems like a couple of disconsolate receivers have just come to terms that they're going to be where they're going to be this year, and that's Brandon Ayuk and T. Higgins, who each want the money and the number one, you know, role
mm-hmm.
in somebody else's passing game, I think, at this point. And but, you know, Higgins, I think, just kind of acknowledged that, yeah, I'll be with the Bengals this year, and I think Ayuk is in the same boat. And if I'm the Bengals and I'm the Niners, and it's every year is a one-year plan to win a Super Bowl.
Yeah.
When you get a quarterback like those dudes have, every year is a one-year plan.
Sure it is.
So Yeah, if I'm the Bengals, I'm not trading T. Higgins. I'm not letting him go. I am going to franchise him, and I'm going to, you know, line it up and try and, you know, win it again this year.
Yeah, yeah.
The Jags draft seems so simply stated in front of us. I don't know how many other angles we can go to, Hick. I don't – here's what I don't want him to do.
Mm-hmm.
This will anger me. I thought about it. There's only one draft scenario that will really bother me if they
do it. All right.
Don't trade down.
Don't trade
down. Don't trade down. Don't trade from 17 to 28 and pick up an extra third. Mm-hmm. Use the 17th pick to give me the 17th best player in the world in football. Mm-hmm. Because we're not good enough to swap the 17th best player in the world in football for the 28th best player in the world in football. We need the best player in football that we can possibly get. So I wouldn't be opposed to trading up. I wouldn't be opposed to positions. I'm not like, I think there's a big enough position need. What I don't want to do under any circumstance is trade down and give Trent Baalke more picks to mess up later.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Draft savvy guys can trade down and pick up extra picks and use those picks wisely. We shouldn't do that.
I don't want to do that.
We should not do that. We should use that 17 pick on and see what happens. See if corner falls to him. I mean, I think they probably settled on this guy, this guy, or this guy. You know, like when you're at 17, you can't, because we think that this guy may be gone. We think this guy may be gone, but we don't know. And if this guy falls to us, you know, it's like the Josh Allen draft. They didn't think about Josh Allen. All of a sudden, he was there.
I feel like at 17, Dan, that there is going to be a name that falls to you that you weren't expecting.
No, hopefully.
Whether it's Terrion Arnold, whether it's Quinyon Mitchell, whether it's Jared Verse or Brock Bowers or, you know, I think there might be something there that throws a kink into maybe the name that we all had at top of mind.
When you mentioned Jared Verse, is he falls to you? Is that a guy you would take?
I don't know.
Scoop up if he fell to you?
I don't know. We talked about this late last week, but one thing that the Super Bowl champions have in common, in addition to good quarterbacks, is they've all been top three in sacks, man.
Yeah.
We don't get to the quarterback. We're terrible at it.
Yeah.
And imagine a potential lineup with Allen and Verse on the outside and Armstead and Trayvon Walker on the inside. And by the way, you still got Roy Robertson Harris. You still got Hamilton.
Yeah.
I mean, that's intriguing to me. Now, at the same time, though, we need a receiver, man.
Yeah.
We sure need a receiver. And we also need a corner. So both are going to be addressed. I imagine edge rusher is going to be addressed. Can the Jags and Trent Baalke do the right job of predicting and projecting the best spot to take those prospects?
By the way, we'll go full circle. You mentioned OJ earlier in the program just a few minutes ago, and it got me thinking back to 1994. And three things happened that year that haven't happened since, and that is in 1994, the Knicks and the Rangers both won 50-plus games. Rangers won the Stanley Cup.
Knicks went to the final.
And Knicks went to the final in the OJ chase.
OJ went on the run.
So maybe OJ's, being in the news again will spark the New York City clubs to do something.
Oh.
I don't know.
Well, I don't know if he'll still be in the news by the time we get to summer, being dead and all.
Summer!
Although it looks like his greedy, bloodthirsty family is going to, deny the court, demanded a payout to the Goldman family since their dad killed their son in cold-blooded murder.
Jeez, dear. All right, so let's do this. We got a lot ahead here. We're at the Guggen Open at Hidden Hills.
Yeah, the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. We're going to have fun today. I'm a little disappointed of no Mr. 10 because he's become my 9:30 crown and 7 guy.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're going to go all out for the Guggen Open, we're going to go all out. You know, usually he'll get me right before tea time with a little rain session, if you know what I mean. So
that's just,
not that I wouldn't want to see him anyway. I should be clarify that.
Spirits.
Is there any such thing as a dark horse in the NBA playoffs now that the field is set, the play-in is set? That's happening Tuesday, Wednesday, and then Thursday, Friday.
I don't think there's overwhelming favorites. Would you take, I don't know who the betting favorite is. Is it the Nuggets or
sure.
is it Oklahoma City?
No, it's the Nuggets and it's the Celtics
would
for
you,
sure.
Would you take them or the field? Like, do you think somebody will beat one of those teams or not?
I don't feel super strong, but if you're giving me the Nuggets, Celtics versus the field, I would take that, yes.
You would take what?
I would take the Nuggets and the Celtics versus the field.
Okay. I'd take the field. Because I'm rooting for the field, so.
No, I hear you. Therefore, I would take the field. I don't like the field at all. I think the field's full of a bunch of.
I think there's some good East
is terrible, Dan. I don't know how anyone's going to beat Boston in seven unless they decide to be terrible. Boston was really good this year. What did they win, 65 games?
Yeah, they won a lot.
Really good. Like, really a lot better than.
Get us to the Eastern Conference Finals. We'll take our chances with them.
I can't get the – this computer's not working right. I'm trying to pull up the odds. Gibby, can you pull up the odds on your phone for the NBA – odds to win the NBA championship? I'm sure it's Denver's number one and Boston's number two, I would think. In the East, Hick, to your – who in the East would you think would be – like, you're on, I mean, your team's a two-seed. You don't want to concede anything. I get that.
No.
Say the Knicks aren't. Who in the East do you think could beat Boston in a seven-game series where Boston's the home team?
Maybe Philly.
Philly?
Here you go, Jeff.
If Embiid is healthy, yeah, maybe.
The Celtics are the favorite to win the NBA.
Yeah, I figured.
They're the favorite to win the championship, only plus 165. Denver is next at plus 300, and those two teams are a mile ahead of anybody else.
That's according to FanDuel.
But this is betting, though. This is the betting odds, which is actually about. The Clippers are next at plus 1,200. The Bucks are
Clippers.
Plus 12-1, Clippers and Bucks. Oklahoma City 16-1, Minnesota 19-1, but your favorite at just basically 1.5-1, Boston, and then 3-1, Denver. So to your I'll tell you this: you identified if you're going to say these two are the field. Well, those are the two.
Yeah,
that's for sure.
We'll see. We'll see.
I enjoy the NBA playoffs, and I do think if there is here's what takes away from the dark horse appeal. The team, like a dark horse by nature, would be a team that is lower in the standings, right? But in both conferences, you got good teams that are low. I mean, for Pete's sake, Sacramento and Golden State aren't even in the playoffs.
Right.
And if they make it in, they're an eight. Certainly Golden State could upset somebody.
Sure they could.
It's not a good play-in for Oklahoma City.
No.
I mean, they got eight, you know, you got good teams down there between 7 and 10 that they're going to have to face in round one coming off all this time with no playoff experience, so – and then in the dark horse on the other side, I mean, Miami and Philly are 7-8. I mean, those are good teams.
Yeah.
If they both make it through, and I know who won't. The Atlanta Hawks are awful. The Monday morning running back is next here. It's the Monday morning quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
Interesting.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Radio professionals.
Facial.
That's just me not being able to speak.
Holy smokes.
Yeah. Hey, buddy, I've only been doing this for 20 years.
Achievers dash for...
That's ridiculous.
1010XL.
One more time, I promise.
What makes a Honda certified pre-owned vehicle so special? 182-point inspection, 24/7 roadside assistance, first-year free oil changes, and a 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty for carefree driving backed by American Honda. Visit your local Honda dealer today.
Make sure your roof is ready for the next Florida storm by scheduling a complimentary roof inspection with Universal Roof and Contract. And right now, get $200 off your roof repair and $500 off a roof replacement. Plus, no interest for 1 year. This offer expires April 30th and restrictions apply. Ensure peace of mind before the next storm hits with Universal Roof and Contracting. License number CCC057165, CBC125-8484.
UniversalRoof.com.
Hey folks, Hicken here for Zero Res. If you're like me, you're getting the itch to do some deep cleaning. Problem is, most of us hate throwing things away. Man, I just close my eyes and let my wife do it. And we always call Zero Res for our floors. We'll have the Zero Res crew clean all the flooring because this month, gang, all flooring 25% off. That's right, 25% off carpets, tile and grout, wooden vinyl floors, and area rugs. Great time to get all the floors clean. Zero Res, man. Spell it forwards or backwards. Zero Res. It's the right way to clean.
Zero Res.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing. Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. B-E-T-R-O-S Plumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time, in fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing, and it's serious, and it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th, bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena. Guns and Hoses.
Do you have clicking, popping, swelling, or pain in your knee or shoulder? This can be due to arthritic changes in your joints. Over time, you have wear and tear of your cartilage. I am Dr. George Bari, and here at Bari Orthopedics, we have numerous ways to treat your arthritis, such as regenerative medicine, including PRP, and joint replacements with CT guidance for accuracy down to the millimeter. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, call us for an appointment today, or log on to BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
Pross, I'm thinking about changing my name.
Again? You're already the media mogul, the straw that stirs the drink, the Duke of Pablo Bay. Now what?
Refer to me as Dreamfinders Danny Hicken.
What in the blazes? Is this a cash grab?
No, it's just that I believe so much in Dreamfinders Homes. 20 locations in Northeast Florida, official home builder of Jags and Gators. Great opportunity for first-time homeowners.
All right. Dreamfinders Danny it is.
Did I mention the lowest interest rates you can find? Visit DreamfindersHomes.com. Now let Dreamfinders Danny celebrate through the majesty of song. Dream finders,
oh, brother.
I believe they will build your
stop.
Home just right.
It's Need to Breathe, live at Daly's Place, April 28th. For your last chance to win tickets to Need to Breathe, text BREATHE to the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures at 641-1010 now.
Our slogan, Know Before You Blow, applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too, so know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too, so know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Offices Jacksonville.
Yo, E to the T here, and we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino, canceled because real life came calling. My Bookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action. All from the comfort of the crib, my boy. I love the live casino. Just go to My Bookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find the dealers ready to spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience with the actions in your hands, and you don't even need to wear pants, my guy. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL and a revamped loyalty program that'll ensure the host an exclusive VIP perk. So sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win. Only with MyBookie. Come on, somebody.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards, get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508, 904-999-1508, or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Now, Dan and Jeff hand it off to our halfback.
Fred Taylor, every time he touches it, he's a candidate to go the distance.
Monday morning running back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein & Robbins DUI defense firm and B&B Fuel & Lubricants on 1010XL.
Yeah, hold on.
He got out on the field. I'm sure he did. I don't think it was as a running back.
I think you got him now.
We got him. Fred, you there?
You still ain't caught me yet. What's going on?
So you heard, did you hear us at least, I hope? We didn't hear you.
You
heard us?
I did. Now they only heard music that put me in the mind frame of Sweet Home Alabama. And let me tell you this. For years, I never knew why we pumped that through the loudspeakers.
Then you learned.
2 years maybe. And then I learned. I learned that the boys in the band was formed in Jacksonville and all that other good stuff.
Oh, Ed White High School.
I had a deeper appreciation for the song after that to this day.
Yeah. Fred, you know they named the band after like their geography teacher or something. His name was Leonard Skinner.
I did not know that. Yeah. Keep schooling me.
Fred, there we go. Turn it up.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, Freddie, we were at the Googan Open. And it's a yearly thing that we do here, and it's a golf outing for the fellas. And you like golf. You play golf, right?
Yeah, I get it in sometimes. Well, I haven't played it in a while. The pivot has taken over my entire life.
It has taken over your life.
Yeah, man, so I don't get an opportunity to play as often. But when you end up finding yourself in a Emmy nomination, then I guess it's all worth the sacrifice and the time. So I never thought I would be an Emmy nominated anything, but here I am today, and my golf game has suffered a lot because of it.
First off, kudos and congrats to the Emmy.
It's been a fantastic. It's just been a fantastic endeavor. I think you probably started just wanting to kick it around with the boys, and it's become very popular. Fred, if you had who's been your like best guest to this point, or the most memorable
man? You know, we get that question from time to time.
Man,
sure. But you're right, Jeff. It was just started to get out of the house during the pandemic, and then it eventually became this. But I think my favorite guest to this point has been Michael Beasley, because it was so much unknown, and we weren't sure exactly what we were going to do as a podcast. We just wanted to do a lifestyle pod, sports pod, and Mike came in, and he just opened up and – from there, we showed, or we proved, that we were able to be a group of guys to be as vulnerable as we were that night. And that show sort of transcended and became what the Pivot is today. It's about transparency, truth, vulnerability, being open, giving back. And Mike, for me, kind of elevated and gave us that direction, man, and said, it's okay. It's okay. So he's been my favorite guest because our trajectory kind of went, you know, positive, went upward after that episode.
I think the listeners would like to know, Fred, just a little bit of inside the Pivot, if you will, in terms of, like, how far ahead do you guys work? Because I know you want to get something timely, and yet you don't want to be – and you want to have a couple in the can in case something happens or you're not
–
so how does that work? How many do you have right now that you could go to if you needed to?
Well, we exactly what you said right there, Jeff. We basically we just go and grind, you know, in terms of keeping costs down. When we travel to a city, if we have a big target, bigger name guest, we'll go there and we'll try to get, you know, other guests around it. If we can shoot 3-4 in a day, we'll do that and knock it out, because a daily rate is a daily rate for the production team or the guys that we contract to come in and be the camera crew, the sound people, et cetera, et cetera. So their daily rate is 10 hours. So whether we shoot 1 hour or 10 hours, that's all consumed within that particular booking. But if we can get 3 or 4 in a day, we'll do that. I believe now we have about 5 or 6 in the can. And you're right. We try and do more evergreen stuff where it's not time stamped, but some things we just have to get it in and get it out. And our producer, Alicia Zubakowski, who's also an owner in the pod, Alicia has 12 Emmys in her home that are just beautiful. She comes from NFL, inside the NFL, NFL Films. Sable, Steve Sable is her mentor. Rest in peace, Mr. Sable. So she has a knack for, you know, saying, look, Fred, Ryan Channing, this is what I want. This is what we need. So she's a big drive. She's our quarterback. Like, she's the unsung hero, and we get all of the credit on the front end. But yeah, we have a good team, man, and we try and just kind of use our best. We're going to California tomorrow, actually, to do Caleb Williams, and then we'll probably drop that on a Tuesday, because Tuesday, Friday is our sweet spot. But we try to use our bigger guests for our bigger day, which is Tuesdays. And Fridays, we've learned to use those days as a three-man show, where we're just talking about trending topics and all that stuff.
Right. Let's pivot to a Jaguar issue.
Let's do it.
I'm worried about the running game. I don't know if I'm worried about the running backs. I'm not worried so much about ETN. I think we saw in his second year, what was essentially his rookie year, when the line performed at least okay, you know, he would get more than expected. But we didn't see anything from Tank Bigsby last year. And, you know, Fred, I feel like there's been a little bit of passing the buck between the front office and the coaching staff, and Trent Baalke went with the onboarding phrase. What do you expect of Tank Bigsby? Are the Jags okay at that position going into the draft and the rest? Can they just fill in some running back depth? I know they kept D'Ernest Jackson too, right? What is it going to take for Tank Bigsby to flash as a weapon rather than a guy to get a couple of carries when ETN has to come out?
Yeah, I don't think there's an extreme sense of urgency to draft a back. I wouldn't take a back at all if I were the Jaguars. I think they have a really solid running back room. I really like Bigsby. The only thing that I don't like is he's shown that he's capable of putting the ball on the ground. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason. That's the real reason that he's not playing. They can't trust him right now. And when you're not trusted as a ball handler, then your reps and your minutes are going to sacrifice there, and you won't play. So, and I like D'Ernest. You know, he's shown some flashes for what his role is. He's a great third down back, a change of pace back. I think in itself, I like to see the scheme. You know, I love inside zone, outside zone. I'm not a fan of the toss at all. But sometimes you can throw it in every 100 run plays. Here, toss it just to change it. But that's just me. I know they do a lot of quick toss and all of that to the bunch side, two-man receiver side, and the condensed package. But, again, I do love inside zone, outside zone. I think it gives the running back the ability to just be just that, the running back. You're the runner. You're able to find a hole, pick a hole, find a hole, burst, get through it, get the tough 4 or 5 yards. And with that, you're also able to do some change up and utilize Trevor. He's a quarterback that's very athletic, can really run the ball. You got some boot action. He's strong at boot action. That old Peyton Manning wide stretch outside zone threat, get the ball deep. You can use intermediate routes behind it on three different levels. You can threaten the defense and with that action. RPOs, you know, you can create a lot of mismatch and some stuff utilizing, taking advantage of the defensive end in the RPO package. And that comes off the inside zone. So, I mean, I just think the schemes can be simplified. A lot of times we try and do too much. But I know what we did back in the day to make our run game better was say, look, what's your 3 or 4 favorite plays? That's going to be the bread and butter, and we'll do other stuff as a change of power, counter, you know, that stuff, get creative. But, yeah, I think the run game is going to be okay. They just got to all communicate it from the front, display a lot of effort, and when it's time to find the right lane and hit it, you got to do that. But I like Tank. I wouldn't give up on him just yet. He's bigger than I thought initially from when we drafted him and me seeing him on tape. But seeing him in person, he's a nice-sized back, and I think he's capable. So give him another shot, but he has to handle the ball better.
You know, it's interesting you brought up Tank Bigsby, because I want to ask you this question, Fred. I want you to go back to your rookie year. I don't have anything in front of me, but you burst onto the scene. It was like the second week, third week, in Baltimore game, 80, I don't know, in my head, I think of 80-yard run or something.
Had a long touchdown catch that game too. Yeah,
help me. Why? Take me through a rookie running back. Take me through what's going through your mind and why, if you don't develop that first year, you say don't give up on him. But what he went through last year wasn't what you went through, and why were you able to succeed so well?
And on top of that, Fred, you didn't have to get shell-shocked because you had guys like Baselli and Searcy on that offensive line. That probably is part of this conversation too, no?
Yeah, I think for me, let me just say year one to two, mm-hmm. the awareness that you develop in that amount of time and the confidence that comes along with it all, like right. is night and day. My year one and two, albeit I did get banged up early on, but I went on to, I had the hamstring that year. So that mm-hmm. kind of kept me back and forth in the lineup. But the awareness in itself, even in that preseason, I was like, whoa, I'm going to destroy this league. And then the hamstring issue started to happen. But going back to year one, my rookie year, I came in like all rookies do. Stumbling, bumbling, falling over yourself, tripping, you know, in practices. That's the stuff you guys don't see. You know, you're trying to run right. so hard. You try your best to impress the coaches. You end up falling over your own feet a lot of the time. And I was that rookie. I was a guy who, and I know Tom McManus loved this, him and Brent Boyer, they would always bully me in a fun way, in a loving, we got to make this guy tough way. And they would just try me. And I welcome the challenge. All right, Kevin Hart's not trying me, but these guys are trying me. Give me your best shot because I'm getting more reps against those guys who weren't the number one. So mm-hmm. for a while, I had to endure what they were trying to give to me, and I got past that stage and started competing versus.
Yeah, but Freddie, I don't want to interrupt, but you stumbled and bumbled your way to 17 touchdowns and 1,200 yards.
Oh, he said he figured it out, by the way.
That's a part of the process, and that's what I was trying to build is, that's yeah. true, but I was trying to build the process because the running game is just that. You can get, you know, stifled and stuff for, you know, 10, 12 plays, and mm-hmm. then, boom, you got an 80-yarder, and before yeah. you know it, you got 11 carries for, you know, 90 yards or something like that.
Gotcha.
That's the Dolphins game, my rookie year, is exactly what happened. But, you know, I truly believe that give Tank time, he has an opportunity to change directions and come around because he's a solid runner. I think he's a pretty good pass protector. My issue, much like the coach's issue, is handling that football. And if you can't sure. handle it, you will not play. I wasn't a big fumbler. Someone posted something the other day and said, well, I was a fan of Fred Taylor until he became fumbling Fred. I was like, wait a minute.
No,
I played 13 seasons, 27 fumbles. That's yeah. two per year. I still don't love it, but when you compare that, any guy that's had over 2,500 carry touches in their career, the yeah. Edgerrin James, the LaDainian Tomlinson, the Emmitt yeah. Smith, the Barry Sanders, all of those guys are clearly in their 40s.
Right.
I remember the greatest that I've ever played.
I remember one game Fred fumbling, and he took it out very severely on FSU later in that same game.
That's
the game I
remember. That's one of my and many, many, many hundreds of thousands of Gator fans' favorite game, that 97 game in the Swamp. Yeah. Two fumbles early mm-hmm. on, and that turned into
which was unlike you, as you're saying. It was the same thing in college. You weren't a fumbler. It was unlike you, and buddy, with a vengeance. That remains probably many of us Gator fans probably one of our favorite games all time. What a great day! Who's on the pivot
young,
this
young
week, Fred?
Back. Say again, guys.
Who we got on the pivot this week? What do we got?
I believe we're going to drop Jamal Crawford. We went basketball heavy.
Makes sense.
Yeah, we got J.J. Redick. We got Jamal Crawford. They're both in the can. We got DeVal. He's an actor.
I put you on the spot, man.
His last name right now. I am having a brain fart right now. But we have quite a few. DeVal Ellis. My apologies.
There you go.
Just an amazing episode with DeVal. Former player. Hofstra. Spent some time in Detroit, undrafted. special teams. He had a 3-4 year career, parlayed that into post career. Now he's an actor. He does some amazing work, big influencer as well on social media. So we have a few guys, and then we're going to go and try and get Kevin Garnett after we do Caleb Williams.
I like that.
And we'll
like
make sure we drop Caleb way before the draft. So,
all right, Freddie, next Monday we need a name. We need a name of the guy you want. Who you want them to pick. Who you want the Jags to pick if he's there.
1 week.
If he's there, next Monday. You mean without moving, without.
Yes. That's right. At 17.
But you can also give us a scenario if you want to trade up to get your guy Rome, because I know you like him now.
I mean, I think I do like Rome. Does it make sense? Does it make sense to go after a young guy who's not proven in this particular level, but he does have amazing potential? Or do you empty the wallet, give away a few picks, and go and get a Brandon Ayuk who's requested a trade? Someone who's a savvy vet who's only gotten better each of his 4 years. So,
correct.
I mean, you have some stuff. You have some draft capital. You have some wiggle room if you want to do that. Or you get a young guy and groom him, and that way you know he's not going to really conflict with your star player, which is Trevor Lawrence. Because that chemistry has to eventually find itself some sort of way.
Appreciate you, everyone. Freddie, thank you so much, my man.
Love you guys, man. Appreciate you. See you next next Monday. I'll be ready.
Awesome. Right,
there he goes.
Talk to you then. That's the Monday morning running back, our fave. That's Fred Taylor. We're back with more. We're live at the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open. We're trying to do the math here. It's like 17th, 18th one of these bad boys, and we are going to have a good time today at Hidden Hills. Our hosts have been very gracious and good to us through the years, and we're looking forward to having a great day out on the golf course. So we'll be back with more. We still are going to talk with E. Do we have Jason Gibson? I know they didn't have a game this week. Do we have the Sharks head coach this week, or is that next week?
Yeah, I believe we still have him.
All right, so we'll get a quick preview of this week's home game, and they've had a week off, and perhaps to introduce a couple new wrinkles. We will also be joined with by Matt Every for some more Masters recap coming up in the 9 o'clock hour, at least we hope, at least for a quick minute or two before we're done today as well. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com. Back with more next.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. It's more than a game.
No matter how talented you are, it still comes down to that brotherhood of playing for one another.
1010XL. It's why we play.
There are only a few things the government does well, and processing passports is not one of them. Hello, it's Congressman Aaron Bean, and taking care of constituents in Northeast Florida is a top priority. If you need help with that passport, the VA, Social Security, or any federal agency, call my office, 904-557-9550, or visit bean.house.gov. I'm Congressman Aaron Bean, and serving you is what we do. Paid for by official funds authorized by the House of Representatives.
It's one of life's most important decisions. If you're 18 years or older, you just got married, you just got divorced, you have children, you likely want to take care of your family. Of course you do. You can hear from Matt Hinson in the Hinson Law Firm. I'm not the attorney yet. But have you done your last will? It's not the most comfortable thing. It's not the most fun thing to do. It's something you need to do besides getting your assets to the people that you want them to go to. Planning helps minimize income, gift, and estate taxes as well. Matt Hinson will listen to help you with some tough decisions. He'll provide you the info needed so you are at ease with your choice. The Hinson Law Firm. You have questions? Matty's got answers. 904-527-1700. 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
Does the building you go to work in every day need a little love and attention? Jason Parker here with Performance Painting. Great companies take great care of the buildings their staff and customers walk into every day. If the building you're in doesn't match the vision you have for your company, we can help. Go to performance-painting.com. Our highly trained team makes the difference. Quality coatings applied with pride.
Performance Painting!
Joe C. for CSS Fireplaces and Outdoor Living. They can transform your backyard with fire pits, pergolas, screen enclosures, and outdoor kitchens. And CSS handles the entire project from start to finish. You dream it, they build it. CSSOutdoor.com.
Roland Reisch Plumbing. There when you need them.
Big or small plumbing problem, call Roland Reisch Plumbing anytime at 260-7059. 260-7059, where quality and experience count.
A lot of companies will tell you they're the best. At Custom Tree Surgeons, they show you every time. Custom Tree Surgeons has built an all-pro team. Every tree service professional has years of experience, continually trained and certified. They know what, when, and how to handle any job. It gets done efficiently and quickly by a team of experts. So for tree trimming, removal, stump grinding, and emergency services, forget any name other than Custom Tree Surgeons. There is no job they can't do better. Go to website, CustomTreeSurgeons.com. That's CustomTreeSurgeons.com. And let them show you how the job is supposed to get done.
Who's on Jacksonville's big board?
This guy could give us a new spark.
1010XL covers every angle of the draft.
This your team?
Yeah.
Listen for draft previews brought to you by Big Brothers Big Sisters of Northeast Florida.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit RepublicServices.com.
Equal opportunity.
David Garrard here. Playing in the NFL can put a lot of wear and tear on your body, especially your knees. Southeast Orthopedic Specialist has kept me mobile and ready to tackle every day.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
David Garrard here. I've had the PRP treatment from Southeast Orthopedic Specialist, and my knees are really doing well. Platelet-rich plasma treatment may be the answer for whatever is hurting you.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny.
Coastal Equipment.
If you have experienced problems when it comes to selling your home, maybe it's just because you have not discovered Chad and Sandy and ChadandSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. You can call them at 904-414-6200. But here's the bottom line. Your home will be sold, guaranteed, or they'll buy it. So whatever you think your problem may be, whether you need more space for an office or growing family, or you want maximum equity from your home, but you're not sure how, Chad and Sandy deliver with a promise. And at the bottom line, it ends with your home is sold at an agreed upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. That is the definition of a guarantee. The proof is out there. Pete in Lakeshore writes, I was in a pickle. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio, and I called because I needed cash out on a rental property fast. I was struggling to rent. Chad and Sandy got a full offer, full asking price within days. Go to ChadandSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. Or call 904-414-6200 today.
At Andy's Automotive and Truck Services, they know that your company's fleet is more than just a bunch of cars and trucks. It's your livelihood, your reputation, your pride. So when you need routine fleet maintenance or emergency repairs, Andy's offers after-hours and mobile service to minimize your downtime and keep your fleet running like new. While you care for your employees and customers, rest assured Andy's Automotive will take care of your fleet. Visit the team at andysats.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
All right, welcome back to the program. This is The Drill. Coastal Equipment, Guggen Open coming up. Jeff, you like stats.
Okay.
I sit there and hear all the Trae Young stats that you send me, especially when you liked them. Not so much as much lately. But I'll throw this at you, and you tell me. Only three players in NBA history have averaged 28-plus points per game, 6-plus assists per game, 40% plus from three-point while playing 77 games in a single season. Larry Bird won the MVP. Steph Curry in 2016, he won the MVP. And Jalen Brunson.
I knew it wasn't Trey Young. I was saying, where are you going? You can't even play that many games. No, I'm a big believer in Brunson.
I think it's probably
too late to get the MVP momentum. I think if people had recognized, because uh-huh. he's been doing this all year.
Right.
If people had recognized this in February mm-hmm. instead of April, that, I think he may have had enough momentum. But I just.
Two seed in the East. Randall missed 36. OG missed 27 of the 50. Mitch Robinson missed 51. I just would say this. Nobody, and again, you guys watch the NBA more, so your opinion matters on this than me. But I would say nobody did more for his team than Jalen Brunson. I have plenty more stats to back up the MVP, where the elite season that this young man has had for the Knicks. But I don't think anybody did more for his team.
I think the NBA, by the way, the NBA kind of by definition, that's how a lot of teams are successful. They have a guy who does so much. Like, I don't know where the Oklahoma City would be without SGA.
Right.
You know, I don't know what the Celtics would be without Tatum, although they do have Jaylen Brown, so that's probably not the best example. I think there are other – but I will say this. With no Randle, the Knicks are not an impressive ball club. You feel like if you took Brunson out and just put in your Joe average point guard, that they'd be a 40-win team, not a 50-win team. So mm-hmm. I would have no problem I would have no problem with Brunson being the MVP. I just don't think that he will be.
I don't either. Who is it? Jokic?
Yeah. You know, we talked about this the other day. I mean, if it's not Jokic, I think Brunson, probably SGA will get a smattering of support. But Jokic, I think, is the guy. Mm-hmm. It'll be his third in 4 years. The man in the golf world, it's unequivocally clear. It's Scottie Scheffler. You know, it's interesting, Dan, that old quote cliche ended up being a truism.
Right.
And that is, the Masters doesn't start till the back nine on Sunday. And as they headed to the back lot, back nine, at one point yesterday, there was what? Four or five of them were 6-7 under par. I mean, they made their run at Scottie Scheffler. And then with everyone within a shot or tied for the lead, Scheffler said, bye-bye. He did that to a degree on Saturday when he made the eagle on 13 and the birdie on 15. And he made up those three shots he had given away earlier. That's the only time he was on his heels.
Right.
Was early in the round on Saturday, or midway through the round on Saturday. He went to 13. He'd fallen, I believe, all the way to like 3 under par. And he was able to make an eagle there and then made a birdie on 15. And he got back in the final group on Sunday. And then he kind of just bobbed and weaved and sparred a little bit and then went haymaker on the back nine. And Scheffler, more agreeable? Are you believing more in my speculation around TPC that it's the first guy in a while? He ain't Tiger good, but he may be the first guy where the field admits that if he plays his best, we can't beat him. Still not there yet.
I don't.
I mean, it's hard to get into other people's heads.
I don't disagree much on that one. I mean, I don't know.
Don't you feel that way? I feel like if he plays his best, no one's beating him. No one's beating him.
Yeah, he's in a groove.
Yeah.
How long can the groove remain?
I don't know. And I'm concerned with the way he moves those feet, that his consistency could go AWOL sooner than others.
He'll be the favorite at every major this year.
For sure.
Like I said, he went bogey. He went double bogey, bogey, back-to-back on Saturday. And his odds suddenly went plus 270. And it was a great time to jump in and it was like taking candy from a baby on that one. I saw that Portnoy has been riding the favorite train of late. He's made like $5 million off of UConn. Scheffler, he made $1.35 million. A couple other like obvious bets. He's been playing some favorites and he's been winning.
It's funny you say that.
It's like $5.5 million, big better. He's taken my moniker of Big Game Dan.
Oh.
And he's
you think
of,
he's taking that from you?
He's sort of running with it. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. I was BGD long before he was whatever he is.
I have a buddy who had this scenario going into yesterday, so now we'll be down to one.
Uh-huh.
But same thing as far as riding the favorites. It's a $100 three-bet parlay. He had UConn to win the NCAA. He had Scheffler to win the Masters. Those two are now in. If the Nuggets win the NBA championship, it's going to pay 65-1. Oh, do the math. Ooh. Pretty good day. Be a pretty good payday. Now it's just down to the Nuggets. And so, really, if you can just get the Nuggets to the final, you can fade them or hedge them.
But I was, back to the Masters. Look, Colin Morikawa had a nice round on Saturday. He was right there. He has experience. He and Scotty have a very similar resume, except Colin had two majors and Scotty had one. And if Colin Morikawa wins that, he has three different major belts under his resume, right? Because what did Colin Morikawa win?
He's won two. He won the PGA and the U.S. Open.
Yeah, and then he would have had the Masters if he had won yesterday. So he would have had three of the four. But he didn't, and he kind of fell apart.
It's just
Max Homa, just couldn't make a putt.
The guy who looks like this, the
Ludwig was the guy.
Yeah, and it's awful early just to assume he's going to be great for the next. It's just that's what's amazing about the greats, Dan, about Tiger. You look up 10 years later and they're still doing it.
I remember saying back in November, you gave me no credit and poo-pooed me that Ludwig would win a major this year.
Because I was talking about it before.
Welcome to the club, Hick. I mean everybody said
right.
That.
Blah, blah, blah.
E, did you have that? I was ready to pull that out today if I told you to save that one from back in November.
To your point, I guess, Pop would have been accurate. It bothered me.
There he was in his
like
first
many
major.
Things that I talk about, you just don't, like, you look like you're listening and you don't. I talked about
so
Ludwig.
So you're
like
trying to say that you are on board with Ludwig before
1,000,000%. Yeah. Million percent.
All right. Let's do this. Let's take a break.
Which earns nothing for either of us, by the way, so we can move on.
That's ridiculous. We'll take a break and we'll come back and keep it rolling in the 9 o'clock. We'll get nasty. Right
oh,
here.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Right in the middle of the Guggen Open, perhaps an argument, a swing, who knows what.
Well, if it happens, it'll happen here.
Yeah.
Listening to The Drill, it's the Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
The Drill, from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
Now, another classic moment in Jags history.
Grinnell under center. He'll take the snap and drop back to throw. Pressure coming. He's jumping out to the near side. Pump action, cuts across the 50. Breaks a tackle at the 45. He's at the 40. Mark Grinnell running to the far sideline. Turns the corner, 35-30. Down to the 25. An inside move, leaping for the 21. Mark Grinnell with a masterful run.
Home of the Jaguars, 1010XL.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Calling all fun-loving citizens of Northeast Florida. Freedom Boat Club needs your help. Lisa the Botanista has gone missing. She left a note that said, "Gone boating." But here's the thing. Freedom Boat Club has four local locations, Julington Creek, Jack's Beach, and two in St. Augustine, and over 400 locations across the world. That's a lot of water to cover. Is she water skiing on the Ozarks, whale watching in the Pacific, or island hopping in Spain? Or hiding right here at the Black Creek Rope Swing? Or docking at the Conch House? Wait, has anyone checked Fort George Island? Too much to do on the water. So Freedom Boat Club is offering our best discount of all time, so you can help search. You simply make your reservation, show up, and have fun. I gotta go. I'm hopping on a boat to the fish camp for live music and lunch. Maybe I'll find the Botanista there. Or better yet, maybe you'll join us with the best discount ever and enjoy boating made simple. Don't blame us when you start playing hooky too. Visit freedomboatclub.com.
Hey business owners, Mia here for Window Gang. Picture this: pristine storefronts, gleaming office buildings, spotless exteriors. How? With Window Gang's superior pressure washing, window cleaning, and more. Whether you're a storefront, apartment complex, condo, or office building, Window Gang will transform the look of your business. Plus, they're fully insured and bonded. Call 262-7300 to schedule your free estimate. That's
262-7300. Sports fans, Hick and here, let's talk skin. Myself and Beach's Dermatology. That's Drs. Boudreaux and Metz. You know them. If you're out at the beach, they're reminding you to wear your sunscreen. If you're an active parent hanging at the fields, if you're in your boat, the fish, you like to chill at the sandbar, man, wear sunscreen. If you're the one that decided for years, I don't want to wear sunscreen. Cancer ain't cool either, man. Trust me, I know. So when grabbing the clubs for your tee time, gassing up the boat, grabbing the chairs for your kids' games, make sure you bring the screen. You got any concerns right now? hey, it's easy to go get checked at Beaches Dermatology. They will work with you. They have worked with me for more than 2 decades. Give Beaches Dermatology a call online at beachesdermatology.com.
WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Mueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Mueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Mueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
If you're a business owner and want to learn about federal, state, or local government contracts, plan to attend a free online webinar April 23rd. The Florida Apex Accelerator, in partnership with UNF, provides expert guidance and consultations at no cost. The Apex Accelerator program can make selling to the government less complicated. To attend the free Coffee and Contracting webinar April 23rd, register at unf.edu/sbdc. Then select Training and Event tab.
Here's your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, sponsored by Window Gang Jacksonville. There are many highlights in Saturday's Orange and Blue game. One standout for head coach Billy Napier was quarterback DJ Lagway.
That's the good thing, because you don't know. I mean, you can practice all spring, but when it's time, I think he showed he's a competitor.
Our major league teams around the state in the NBA saw Orlando over the Milwaukee Bucks to secure the fifth seed in the East and will face Cleveland in the playoffs. Miami Heat defeated Toronto. Miami goes to Philadelphia to open the play-in tournament on Wednesday, with the winner securing the number 7 seed. The Jacksonville Icemen were defeated by the Atlanta Gladiators on Sunday's East Coast Hockey League regular season finale, bumping the Icemen to the number 2 seed for this week's Kelly playoffs. They'll face off Thursday against the defending champion Florida Everblades. At your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update, I'm Sam Nelson.
Currently it's 9:10 and it's 67 degrees. Your time and your temp is brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, divorcemenonly.com.
Shout out to Justin Moore from George Moore Chevrolet, the man, the legend here. I like
Oilers fan.
He's an Edmonton Oilers fan. Brooksy's baseball coach is Canadian from Vancouver, Coach Frick, and he is a Vancouver Canucks fan. So,
and as a Rangers fan, you're non-Canadian.
That would be correct. Definitely non-Canadian. Not that there's anything wrong with that.
Let's bring in Sharks head coach Jason Gibson.
Did not lose this weekend.
Well, he's
it's
not in the mood. He's not in the mood
no
for
jokes.
Any, you know.
Wow, that's a low blow, man. That's taking a shot.
I take it that way, coach.
I want to rethink that survey I took about the radio station.
You know what?
He needs a throat punch, coach.
Somebody's got to do this, because then you could come back after you start rattling off dubs and bring this back up and say, you know,
this
bleep
is for
off
Hicken.
This is
all about Hicken. It's damn
just,
disrespect.
Just let the whole game play out. That's all I'm
there
saying.
There you go, baby.
I'm cool with that. It's got to be nice to be home, man. We've talked about the home field, but meanwhile, what has this 2 weeks been like for you? I would think regrouping to a degree, right, based on the conversations we've had.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of regrouping, a lot of, you know, some personnel changes, some regrouping by everybody, just, you know, just really getting used to this style of game. So, and we needed that 2 weeks to kind of get caught up where we're at. So you'll see a different product on the field Saturday.
Was it good to have the week off, Coach?
Yes, because we needed to get people in here and we needed to make sure we're all on the same page, fine tune some things, and continue to, eliminate mistakes, but just again and keep getting accustomed to this game. So I mean, I'm at practice now, and I tell you what, we're a lot better today than we were yesterday.
Good.
That's a fact.
Listen, when you join a new league and you're in a league that is set up as it is as such, how hard is it to get the perfect gauge on the opponent, right? I mean, you look at some college and pro, I mean, NFL, you have a pretty good idea exactly what another team is going to do. Do you have that same advantage this early in year one in the new league?
It's not so much that. It's the unpredictability of the game. I mean, it's there's so many different things you can do from arena, but that excuse can only go on for so far. But, it's tough, you know, and of course the league set us up with a really good schedule. All the teams we've played are all undefeated, so that doesn't help either.
Could explain some things, for sure. Well, we'll let you get to practice, Coach. We got a home game. It's always important. We got a great home crowd. I know there's still juice. JackSharks.com and get those tickets. It's one of the really, when you're looking for some family fun and excitement and entertainment, the Sharks will give you that. And also, by the way, a winning product. That is
absolutely. Make sure. I think it was 904-621-0700. Call for tickets. It's a good crowd this weekend, and we're playing Vegas, and they're undefeated, and it's going to be a great game. So.
All right, well, a little revenge.
Go
on
get
this
him,
week,
Coach.
We'll talk to you next Monday.
Thanks, buddy.
All right, guys. Thanks, bye.
All right, man. Yeah, there he goes on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. That is Sharks Coach Jason Gibson. Sharks back in the arena this Saturday. We're going to be Guns N' Hoses this week, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Time for that again over there at UNF. So lots going on like there are most weekends here in Jayville.
There are a lot of reasons to be worried about the Gators baseball club, but here are three of them. They still have Kentucky, who is 14-1 and first in the SEC. He's 14-1 in the East is really nice. They have Tennessee, who's 10-5, and they have number one Arkansas, who's 12-3 in the West and leading the West. So they have three of the top teams in the SEC still on their schedule going forward. And Florida now 18-17 after the win yesterday, and 7-8 overall in the Southeastern Conference. LSU is 3-12.
What is going on? The two teams that were in the World Series final last year.
There's a little bit of fallout.
LSU was expected to take a bit of a step back, and Florida was not.
Yeah, that I don't
know. A bit, not 3-12 bit, but a bit of a step back. And in Major League Baseball, it feels like for the first time in a while.
Oh, by the way, the Jags are going to do throwbacks this year, too.
Yeah, it's just we don't have much of a throwback. Oh.
Oh, Fort Taylor? Yeah. She'll be out here at noon, so yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
Look at Taylor.
D.D. D.D.'s got – nobody ever sends us roses.
Wow, man. Taylor Dahl getting – Cloud, where is Taylor? We got to get Taylor Dahl on the phone right now, E.T. Yeah. What's going on? Yeah. Should we read this private card? I mean
– I don't think we should do that,
I don't see anything – I don't see Mia's name on here. I don't see Lauren's name on here.
Taylor Dahl taking
it's not helping
the
heels. That's for Taylor Dahl.
Taylor Dahl, man. I mean, these are red roses now. I'm not talking about some sort of Taylor Dahl. Lunch is still on the table, by the way.
Okay.
Signed, mysterious Mr. X. Taylor Dahl, thanks for your blanks. I'm just going to say what that is. I mean, you can fill in, that's all I'm going to do.
You go, girl.
Look at Taylor. Taylor's stepping up here with a dozen reds. Huh?
Yeah.
Does it matter to you? It feels like the Yankees are, like, valid here for the first time in a while.
Well,
it's been a bit of a struggle. I mean, last year I spent all summer. I spent in the morning watching Aaron Boone have a meltdown from the day before, and how they could do this better, how they could do that better, or this call, or this. It's time. Yankees weren't even in the postseason a year ago, and they have a 12-4 record, the best in baseball right now.
Okay.
They did lose yesterday, but 12-3 before yesterday, 12-4 run differential, 21 also, very good. What about Kansas City's got a 37? Plus 37 run differential. You just played them this weekend, or do they have any staying power at 10-6?
There's a couple teams that I'm not, and I haven't followed them. I watched the Royals closely. I didn't know their dudes. They had a little run where they scored 10 runs or more in like 3 out of 4 games, including one against us that they won.
So that can kind of up those stats, kind of skew them a little.
I'm not sold on Kansas City. I'm not sold on Yankees got Soto and Judge, so, you know, but and if they get Gerrit Cole back, then they could be dangerous. We'll see.
What about the pitching?
As the season plays out, there's some teams up there that I'm not too familiar with.
The AL West has been the disaster. It almost looks upside down except for the Rangers at the top, but they're only 8-8. But the Astros are trending disastrous, 6-11, last place.
Yeah.
Seattle, 6-10. And yeah. They had an odd loss yesterday. They got appeal? I don't know. I just saw the very end of it, but had a chance to tie it up with the Cubs and didn't. Uh-huh. And kind of strangely, at least to me, the best division in baseball, at least by the starts here, would probably be the NL Central. You've got 10-4 Milwaukee, 11-5 Pittsburgh, and both the Cubs and Reds 9-6. It's good records. Four of your five, and here are the Cardinals 7-9, and they were supposed to be better this year.
Yeah,
Arenado's off to another slow start. That's kind of become typical of him.
Just so so early, so hard to tell. Like the Brewers, the chairman of the Tax Slayer Bowl, congratulations, officially named.
Oh, yeah, we didn't mention that officially. Yeah. We've known it for so long, but, yeah Andy King now. Now you know who the luncher is.
And the luncher is.
Maybe we should revisit during the football season having the Gator Bowl, you know, X deck on.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
I'd
like to see him, you know, cough up some serious
he should. I mean,
advertising
I know,
dollars.
I know he's throwing his money all around town.
Join us.
Go some our way.
Man, he can host it.
For sure.
As we do that. So, we'll
for
jump
just $10,000 a week, Luncher, you can do that.
Luncher, we're going to take care of you. We're going to make some good things happen for you here. But, anyway, congrats to him as he takes over as the chairman of the what's his title?
Is it the executive director? Is that what it is?
No,
that's chairman.
McGarrity's the guy.
It's the chairman.
Yeah, I got it. Hold on.
No, he's the Gator Bowl chairman.
I got a press release here.
That's it. You don't have to look it up.
Chairman?
He's the Gator Bowl chairman.
You sure of that?
Yeah.
All right. You feel
chairman.
Good about that?
As chairman of the Gator Bowl, you bet. Wow. Ceremonial title.
I think
McGarrity's doing all the lifting.
Oh, yeah.
The luncher just shows up to smile and look pretty.
The luncher grips and grins.
Yeah,
you know,
And you know what? The luncher got to grip and grin a lot this year with that role.
Yeah.
Congratulations being the charity. We need you at the Rotary Tuesday. We need you at the Elks Thursday. You're going to speak to, you know, Lackawanna Middle School on Saturday.
Here we go.
Be terrific. Follow luncher around.
Gator Bowl Sports Board of Trustees recently elected its 2024-25 volunteer leadership during its March quarterly meeting last night. Andy King was announced as chairman.
Yeah, chairman.
For the 2024-25 season. Congratulations to our buddy. He currently serves as a VP at GFL.
And one of the top lunchers in town.
Great
the guy's lunch game.
You want to get him if you
Hall
can get
fame.
Him into the rotation, it is it's fantastic.
Hall and of Fame lunch game.
He does not mention us at all.
That's just disappointing.
In addition to his service with Gator Bowl Sports, Andy has served numerous years for all these different
he's
charities.
He's been working
and such.
Towards this.
Yeah. This is a big deal.
And next will be TPC chairman. Don't kid yourself. The leader of the Redcoats. That's coming.
Not really. The photo, you know, he could have shaved for the photo.
The photo is
a little disappointed
in
the photo.
Is that current?
That's not current.
Yeah, that's like college, isn't it?
Might have thrown in some follicles up top. I don't know.
I think he got a spray tan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like he's got a spray tan working.
I think he's done some LeBron spray hair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Might have.
Yeah.
But it's a nice graphic.
I think he's photoshopped his girth just a little bit.
Yeah.
There's a few things that have happened there.
Yeah.
All may be necessary for a stock photo like that.
Well, he's an impressive.
You don't want to end up like me with some, you know, plaid suit from Studs Pub defining your look.
Former Ripon College great, Andy King. So anyway, congrats to him. Now
that's good.
I was going down a different path, and
okay,
I
go.
Totally forgot.
Well, that'll happen.
Where I was.
You were talking about baseball. No, and then we left that. And then I don't know why you brought up. Were you going college football?
Oh,
somewhere?
The Brewers. Because
yeah.
I'm not impressed as impressed. By the way, the best prospect at all of baseball until he got a hit yesterday was 0-for-12 with 8 strikeouts.
Yeah.
And at that point in time, apparently was the worst baseball player in Major League history, which I tell him only one way to go but up.
Well, we talked Saturday.
We're talking about Holiday.
On the phone. Yeah, and
Jackson
Holiday. I kind of like opened your eyes and I said, you know, your boy didn't have a hit yet.
Yeah.
He's like 0-for-8.
Yeah. Yeah, but he got one yesterday. But the Brewers
I still don't believe in the Brewers. They got a couple of good young players, though, so it's a pitching
camp
either. They got no pitching.
They got Peralta, who's a good
pitcher.
But
that's one, Dan.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, how are you going to keep up with the Braves who have that lineup and have three Peraltas?
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
all.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I will say one good thing about the Braves weekend, and the whole season is sullied right now by the loss of Strider, but Fried finally pitched a game. Which you know is going to happen. He's a good pitcher. He got
hit. Strider had his surgery, I saw.
And it's more than some sort of internal brace or something. We got to talk to Doc about that on Thursday. They're saying it's worse than they expected, not better.
Yeah, career ender is kind of what they're
They're not saying that at all. Just don't say things. Some level of professionalism, even when it comes to these emotional subjects.
I don't think he'll ever pitch again.
I mean, we'll hear, some poor Guggen is pulling into work today, and the last thing he hears is baseball expert Dan Hicken say it's a career ender. Just stop it.
There's a rumor right now that
there is no rumor
pitching for the White Sox with Soroka next year.
Yeah, no, it's no rumor at all to any such sort.
That's not the case.
The only rumor right now is which stud pitcher most sought after at the All-Star break will the Braves get? That's really the only question right now.
Anthopoulos?
He'll do something.
He'll do something.
All right, let's come back into our final segment. I think we're going to get Matt Every on. I'd like to get his thoughts on the Masters and Scottie Scheffler.
Has he showed up?
He sent me a GPS arrival time of 9:23, which is now. So if we go to break, then hopefully he should be here, wound up, and ready to go.
A little poor on Matt's part.
When we return.
Quite frankly.
Well, he had stuff to do.
Did he?
Yeah.
I don't believe
that.
He's
got a family. He had to take kids to school. I don't care if you believe it.
You think that
Matt. Tell him. He's in my foursome. You want me to start bad mouthing, CT? How would you like it?
I will tell him.
Huh?
I will tell him. Do you think Matt Every had stuff to do?
Yes, 100%. What do you think? He slept till 9?
Yeah. You think he was in the office?
You would be surprised. Matty's a bustler more than you think.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that he might have been up, but I don't think he was in the office going
taking
a look at the numbers. Monday morning.
I think he couldn't be here till 9:30 because of stuff that he had to do.
All right.
I don't know in the office or whatever it is you're saying. I don't know why you've turned on our buddy, but I'll be sure to.
Right now on the range, this is odd.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3 lefty golfers in a row.
Oh.
How often does that happen?
I see out in the line of carts, I see former Jaguar Aaron Beasley. Perhaps he could comment on the Jags' throwback uniform announced today.
Killer Bees.
It's hard to have a throwback when your uniform hasn't changed in 30 years.
I'm sponsored today by Chick-fil-A,
I see
by
that.
The way.
That's a nice rope hat, so good for you. Looks like our friends at Dome Hats put that together, looks like.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, you do a good job. Well, good for you. Did you need a hat today or something?
No, I didn't need a hat. It was presented to me because of my choice.
Maddie and the LFG boys are bringing LFG hats for everyone.
Oh, wonderful.
So I don't know where they're going to give those away, seeing that we've already, we've already stepped in. Here they come now, just late to the party. They don't care. LFG's like, here's the catch. You don't want them, don't use them. All right? But they're here now.
He's traipsing up here? So yeah. he didn't hear my
No, that's
dialogue.
Not Matt. He probably heard you out in the so we'll take a quick time out. We'll talk to Maddie about the Masters. Get ready for the Guggen. You're listening to The Drill, the Monday Morning Quarterback Divorce Man, only.com.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Get gear grinding, asphalt winding NASCAR on 1010XL.
This is going to be tight right here.
This Sunday at Talladega, brought to you by the Plumbers and Pipefitters Local Union 234. On your NASCAR station, 1010XL.
Hi, this is Dale Murray with Murray Automotive Group in Stark and Kingsland. Save yourself from those big city dealers and their fast-talking flim-flam tactics. No matter what your automotive need is, we've got you covered. Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram, and nobody beats our prices. And I mean nobody. Shazam! Plus our exclusive 15-year, 150,000-mile warranty included on every qualified vehicle. And we'll trade anything from AirPods to fishing rods. Compare our prices online at ShazamAuto.com. Then come see me, Dale Murray. I'll be waiting for you. Shazam!
Bring your guns and bring your hoses, and we're ready to put up some punches. It's Guns and Hoses Charity Boxing. It's back. It's that time. Bell time. In fact, 6:30, Saturday, April 20th. Join us at UNF Arena. Dan and I there for the millionth year in a row. It is so much fun, this charity boxing. And it's serious. And it's fun, and it's impactful, and you're going to have a great time. By the way, street party before and after the event. Make it a day. Saturday, April 20th. Bell time, 6:30, UNF Arena.
Guns and Hoses.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them. Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Hick and Air Gang, it's time to spring into action and refresh that vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. From dry eyes and allergies causing irritation, to cataracts blurring your vision, Bow Nye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowNye.com and schedule that consultation. Bow Nye and Associates are keeping the First Coast. Okay.
Exciting news from All Pro Roofing. Effective right now, you can get an instant roof quote. Just click the instant roof quote tab on their website. Whether you're in need of roofing, exterior siding, or windows, All Pro Roofing is your local partner for quality craftsmanship. Click the instant roof tab and voila, get an instant quote. It's that simple. Click on the instant roof quote tab today at allproroofingllc.com.
License number CCC 132706.
CDC 060-1.
Well, I'd like to think that you know this already, and I sure hope you have experienced it if you're a pet owner. Because if you're a pet owner, there is only one place that gets you the peace of mind that you want, and it's a perfect name. It's Pet Paradise. It's the ultimate home away from home for your four-legged family member. Whether your pet prefers a splash in the pool or just making new friends, Pet Paradise's team of pet lovers now, pet-loving pros, going to ensure the most important pet in your world has a great visit, whether it's day camp or an overnight stay. Oh, by the way, inside these ultra-modern facilities, dotting the First Coast, I believe 8 or 9 locations now, it's always any and everything you need under one roof. They have professional grooming services, veterinary services with New Day Veterinary Care. At Pet Paradise, it's top shelf customer service and treatment for that member of your family, that four-legged member of your family. So go to Pet Paradise right now. Book an appointment. Find out what they're all about at petparadise.com.
It's Taylor Dahl from Helmets and Heels. You know, I've got to tell you about an amazing experience I had recently. I'm moving, which most of you know can be a very stressful time. I had to get my carpets cleaned, so of course I called up Zero Res, and let me tell you, they did not disappoint. Zero Res came in and worked their magic, leaving my carpets looking brand new. If you want impeccable service and a great deal, it saved me time, made my move a bit easier, and was less than if I took that apartment cleaning fee. Zero Res, spelled backward or forwards, is the right way to clean.
Hey, this is Stevie Beechurst of Beechurst Plumbing. Growing up in Jacksonville, I was always proud when my dad would point at a building and say, "I did the plumbing for that." That's the same kind of pride we instill in every plumber here at Beechurst Plumbing. And that's the kind of pride you can expect when you hire Beechurst Plumbing for your home or business. Right now, we're doing New Year's specials to get your project going. To find out how we can help you, visit BeechurstPlumbing.com. B-E-T-R-O-S Plumbing.com. Beechurst Plumbing, here to help.
Fish are good at hiding. Captain Kevin can help you find them.
Oh, yeah, that's a big one.
Find more fish on the Ring Power Fishing Forecast Show.
Thursday nights at 6.
Brought to you by Awaken 180 Weight Loss on 1010 XL AM.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit RepublicServices.com.
Equal opportunity.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
It is useless to resist us.
All right, we're back. Live at the Guggen. One of the great Guggens. Guggen history is here, Matty Every.
What a compliment.
Well, you are. You've been... You have told us, you've listened for a long time, you're a great Guggen, and you're playing in the Guggen with JP today. That, thank God, that scoring doesn't matter.
Yeah, all about fun today. First of many for me, hopefully.
Yes.
I'm excited.
You'd like to become a regular here.
Yeah.
Speaking of regulars.
You are, by the way, just officially, you are the first champion of the Arnold Palmer Invitational to play in the Guggen. So, yeah.
Is he the first?
Yeah, you'll be the first Arnold Palmer Invitational champion to play in the Guggen.
Are you sure? Did you check the
past
winners?
Yeah, we haven't had Scheffler, Tiger.
Okay.
You know,
players,
Robert freaking Gamez, none of them. Yeah.
Have we had a tour player?
I think Clouk's played before.
Yeah.
Has Clout played the Googans?
I think Clout's played the Googans.
What is Clout doing? You know, I used to live
Clout's a good dude.
I live with Clout's brother in college.
Let me tell you.
John?
Oh, Johnny?
No, the
track one. Yeah.
The Forgotten Clout.
Jeff, isn't it? No, not Jeff's the brother. I think it's another J, though, is it?
John, Jeff, and
John,
and your roommate, by the way. Yes. So good job.
Didn't John play at Texas?
John had a lot going on. there's a few other guys too.
Clout will text us momentarily because he listens
the
all the time.
Yeah. I think it's also a J
Jason,
though, for some
reason.
Jason.
Yeah.
Jason. Matt, listen. I'm being serious.
Yeah.
How can you?
No more kidding.
Continue Matt, to no. How can you continue to consistently hit the golf ball if you move your feet like Scott Scheffler does? Is that? I mean, when he's grooved and he's doing it, but can that hold up over time, or is that going to have to stop at some point?
I think it holds up over time.
You do.
It's just as easy as anything else.
Okay,
it's
an odd look.
It is, but it's his move, and he dominates.
Have you tried to do it? Do you find people trying to do it?
Well, Greg Norman did it. If you watch his footwork, he did the exact same thing. Mark Calcavecchia did it. It's a shallowing move, whether he knows it or not. He says he does it to get to his – make sure he gets to his lead side. But really what it is he might be a little steep on the way down. When he pulls that foot back, it slows his rotation down a little bit and shallows everything out.
Because they say, like, oh, well, he doesn't – his feet don't move until he makes contact. Maloney, yes, they do. They move before he makes contact. It's it's amazing, the timing and the –
all around, though. So,
is he as good as we've seen since Tiger?
Look, he went – what did he go off at? 3-1 to start the week?
4.5.
Okay, whatever. Those are Tiger Woods odds and like in Tiger Woods prime.
I told Pross earlier that when he – on Saturday when he went
– But Dan, him going off at 3 or 4-1, how can you back that?
No, you can't.
Yeah,
you can't.
Right.
Like if they told you can only bet on one guy, you would just put it on him. But if you're trying to play the gambling game, you don't take those short odds against the field.
But on Saturday when he went double bogey, he went +270. Mm. That was a couple guys jumped on it right there.
Yeah, great game.
Yeah, I mean, because
– but it's just you watch him play, he just doesn't mess up. He never stands over a tee shot and you're like, this could get squirrely here.
Never. Right. Like Morikawa yesterday, you know, I see that. Yeah. I see Højgaard on one, see that.
All of them.
You know, he just and he hits it a ton.
And it was really just a matter of like 5 minutes yesterday when Ludvig – rinsed it on 11, and then home as well, went into the bushes the very next hole. That was ball game.
Was Ludvig being too aggressive? Did he miss? Was he trying to go for – because the pin's on that side, right?
Yeah.
So the prudent play is at 11 absolutely is just get your par if you can and get out of there. Sure. Just throw it in the middle of the green, right? Did he just miss? Did he – or was he being too – is that a rookie mistake? What do you think?
This is a fight these guys – fight out there. They're so good. It's so hard to aim away from that far away from something.
Right.
And it's a very penal miss, too. It's not
like
you're dropping right next to the pin. You have to go all the way back in the fairway and drop from 50 yards.
He probably
did get a little too aggressive there.
Okay.
But I wouldn't lose sleep over that shot at night.
Okay. Way. Also explain rules. Like,
I think he's happy to be second,
like,
by the way.
Why did he go to the drop zone and, like, Morikawa and I saw Rory hitting the water, I think the day before, and they went up closer and just pitched it up there. That would have seemed like the better play to me to get it closer.
Well, his ball might not have crossed the line.
He would have to go back on the other side.
Okay.
So there's the actual water itself, but then there's the hazard line that they paint.
Okay.
It might be high up or low down.
Okay.
If it's higher up on the bank, then it probably didn't cross. If somebody's ball like rolled in, different story.
Okay.
What's the difference in a yellow and a red?
Man, you're putting me on the spot.
Right?
Yeah.
It's amazing that like accomplished, experienced,
red,
in this case, professional.
Okay,
they don't know the difference. I played the
red is dead. Yellow is caution.
Yeah, we had a ball going the yellow,
both,
and none of us knew where to take it.
They both suck.
or they never go there.
No, that's not the case. Red, I get. Yellow trips me up every time.
I love that. That's why you have rules officials. I'm going to get a rules official.
Let me get a guy in here.
Hey, Does Scottie Scheffler have that sense of invincibility second only to Tiger in these last 20 years? In other words, if you're – like, I think that whether they admitted it or not, when you were on tour and Tiger was in his prime, you'd say, I can play as good as I can. I'm not beating him if he plays his best.
You're starting to hear it out of his peers' mouths.
I heard Wyndham say that a little bit at TPC, and others are, yeah.
And let's look at the tournaments he's won this year, man.
Right? The three biggest ones so far?
Like big boys.
Yeah.
I mean, big boys. Yeah. I'm with you on that. You know, one of the most impressive things for me with Scotty is, especially in the day and age we're in now, he's completely off of social media.
Right.
And I think that is in his favor big time. I mean, his life is as simple as it can be for how good he is.
Matty, he's a boring dude.
But usually, Dan, to get elite at anything, something's –
you got to play the game.
Well, yeah, but also the social something's probably wrong with you.
Yeah.
You
know? That's fair.
And
that's fair.
He seems pretty normal. Yeah. Man. He does.
Well, that's a great
his
point.
Normal is
thought
so,
of it that way.
Matty, yeah. His normal is so normal, he's abnormal. Because nobody else is that normal.
Yeah, like the answers he was giving yesterday in his presser after were just
– yeah.
They were great answers. They were boring, but he's like, you know, I just really just want to go. I'm just thinking about going home.
Let me get – and they're genuine.
Yeah, they are genuine.
Like when he talks about thanking his savior, it sounds a little different than when Bubba does. Just saying. I don't mean to parse it out, but it's –
I'm not disagreeing with
it. There's a genuineness there. So.
Matty, we were talking about this last week, and I'd like to get your opinion on – Augusta, and let's say four Prossers, you know, like 8, 9,
yes.
10 handicaps were playing.
Yeah.
Tournament conditions with the crowd. Just
I
put,
heard this second.
Yeah, what would they shoot? What do you think?
Well, first of all,
this
weekend. What I remember from this segment was Prosser just pumping his own tires about how good a putter he was.
That's fair. That's fair. That's exactly what I did. That is accurate.
If you played, all right, then didn't you read some other guy too? Had
yes,
he was
he
a
shot,
15.
Yes, he shot.
And he shot 102.
And you went
or
over like his play-by-play.
Yes,
right?
Okay, yes.
Well, I was listening to that, and when you got to number four, and he said he had 178.
Yeah,
that's not the tournament tees. But
I don't
know if they'll let you play the tournament tees.
Right.
If you just go there. So all right.
What does it play in the tournament? 70 what? Four.
Probably about.
Yeah.
But if it's a little cold out, it can be a long
right.
It's a long 7,400 yards.
Right.
The ball's not rolling a ton, especially if you're landing into upslopes and
right.
stuff like that.
People don't know that if they haven't been there.
I do think – so you're telling me – you're asking me if Prosser could break 100 at Augusta in tournament conditions?
Yes.
Be close.
It'd be really close.
Okay. I would play to break 100. I wouldn't play to shoot my low score.
Right.
And I know putting –
But it's a different animal. I get it. I'm not
totally
trusting.
Different
yeah.
animal,
right.
man. You've got elite putters out there.
Would you?
100%.
It would help him if his caddy said, I'm just telling you, put it over there on this putt. Like, that would be a benefit.
Like where the misses are and stuff
well,
like that?
Well, like, yeah, for him just to know. Like, he might read it.
Yeah,
you know,
I think a local caddy can
that's
help
a tough.
Someone,
this know, feels like the 11-minute mile to me. Like, I can make some mistakes and pace myself but still get underneath.
I do think those local caddies are a little overrated up there.
You do? Well, okay.
At a certain level.
Because Fleetwood used one. You saw that, right?
He had to. And it turned out great. What a week for that guy.
Yeah.
I mean, he's gonna make – what did Tommy end up finishing? Fifth?
Yeah, it was four under, right? So
I love this when you get a guy having a great year where it's the old where's Scott Scheffler's caddy on the money list. I love when we play that game.
Well, that's his fourth Masters.
He's won $12 million this year in just those three tournaments.
Yeah.
Players, API,
$12 million
Masters,
in like 36 days.
Like that's the 10% first place. Like I think we always overestimate what the caddy's getting, but they get that 10% on a win, no?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So, I mean, that's $1.2 million for being a caddy, bro.
That's a good week.
Second best job in golf this year isn't a player. It's being Scott's caddy, dude.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, what a guy to caddy, too. I mean, he's you know, a lot of these elite guys over time, you know, you mentioned Bubba, he would wear that guy. He would wear
Ted Scott
out.
Was his guy.
Oh,
yeah.
The complete opposite with Scott.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Scotty's very accountable. If he doesn't – if he does something bad, he's
that
never
Ted Scott dude's got to be in heaven.
Oh, what a move.
Going from there to there.
What a move.
And to get a second chance. I mean, Bubba was pretty successful.
Yeah.
He did just fine. But now to get Scotty Scheffler is just – that was – and even it was cool of Scotty to wait – you know, Ted, let's go. You know, walk with me up the – after he won.
That was
so cool. They walked together up there. That was kind of neat.
What do you remember most about the Masters and what – where did it rank in as far as, like, career, like, achievement
well,
when
like
you
the,
went?
The pinnacle. But the first time I went –
Chang knows everyone, by the way.
Huh?
Chang's my guy.
Everyone. He knows everyone in the world. It's the most amazing thing.
Speaking of, he was there probably every day last week. At the Masters.
Oh, gosh, yeah. This guy, I don't know what. He must have married. I don't know what he does.
He did. With the lotto.
Yeah. She's got to be in charge of everything because Chang, I mean, he's just a dude. Look at him. Walk around in a goat belt playing another tournament.
I mean,
that's my club guy. Remember I had a club guy?
Yeah, yeah,
grips
yeah.
and all that?
Yeah,
that's my guy.
Yeah.
Club guy, Chang.
Club guy.
Got a guy.
Oh, man, the Masters from just my family stuff is what I remember the most. My first year in, I was dumb enough to think that I had a chance.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd won the
– Who won your years there? Do you know?
I think Spieth and some
– Oh, you caught Spieth this glory year. Yeah.
But the first year, the tournament before, I had won.
Bay Hill.
I took a week off.
Right.
It was the Masters.
Right.
And so I was –
Coming in there hot.
I was.
Top.
I mean, there's people riding, like, you know, top 10 guys.
Yeah, watch out for Matt Every.
Sure.
Yeah.
Idiots. Just looking at the first time I played, man, on Thursday, I looked over and saw my mom to the right of the tee right after
awesome.
I had hit, and she was tearing up, and it was tough.
That's great.
But that's what I remember the most.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Have you played the golf course except for when you went and played the tournament?
No, that's it.
Yeah,
a couple times.
Does the golf course stand out as a favorite course? I mean, just growing up as a kid or watching
not really.
It? No, just the course.
Not really.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on there.
Yeah. Oh man, right. Is there?
I don't know how many putts I'll have today, but you'll be able to witness them all.
Yes,
we'll have to come up with some sort of game
best.
Between you and your highfalutin top level golfers, and
me
and the legend Kenny.
Like
we'll just see what we can't grind.
Since November. This should be fun.
You know what? I got no respect.
He was bragging on you.
Yeah. Always.
But my back is feeling great today.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if it was it. I don't know. Was it on air? Where you talked about when you played with him at Windsor and. You know, he had a bad hole, and all of a sudden he shot 66.
Yeah, he does like 66. He like hacked the whole way. You know, it's unbelievable. These guys. No, I said, had he known, because you don't remember this round, it's no big deal to you. But first of all, kudos to Matt Every. Just saddles up and goes and plays Windsor with
right,
us. Okay,
right,
first of all,
right.
Man of the people, Matt
right.
Every.
He's a man
but
of the people.
But secondly, he shot 66, which he won't remember. It's no big deal. But in that 66, there was a hole that he just tried some stupid shot. That if he was really trying to go low, he shot 66 with a double. You remember the hole I'm talking about? You don't even remember.
He doesn't remember.
There's the par 5 that runs along the road,
yeah,
and it's got the lake in the front. And if you drive it left, you can get blocked a little bit.
Is that Frank Franchi over there?
Yeah, sure
is.
Yeah.
Never met him.
Okay.
But
wow.
He didn't want to hear me brag on him. And he doesn't remember a thing about the round.
Neither.
So there's both of those.
Yeah. All right, Matty. Good to see you, my brother.
I ask a two-time winner of the Arnold Palmer if he remembers a hole at Windsor. How's that going to go?
I like that.
Goodbye.
All right, we're going to put a wrap on it. It's the Monday Morning Quarterback, DivorceMenOnly.com. We will hand it off to Jaguars today and go try our luck here at the Hoogan Open.
The Drill on 1010XL. From the studios of Republic Services, we'll handle it from here. Spend lunchtime with the ladies.
A meal and sparkling conversation.
Helmets and heels.
Mia O'Brien, Lauren Brooks, and Taylor Dahl.
Just behave, okay?
Switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans on 1010XL.
I'm Frank Frangie with the Nimnik Nugget. Good for the Jags, good for Josh Allen that Josh is staying. The Jags signed him to a 5-year, $150 million deal with $88 million guaranteed. It makes sense for so many reasons. Number one, he has 17.5 sacks. I think he will go down as the best sack specialist in Jaguars history. But beyond that, he fits the culture, he fits the town. You rarely get a guy that fits in that many ways, which is why Josh Allen should be here for the long haul. Good for the Jags and good for Josh. I'm Frank Frangie for the Nimnik family of dealerships. There are trucks, and then there's the truck, the GMC Sierra. Frank Frangie here with available features like the V8 engine, the ultimate luxury interior, and, of course, the available world's first 6-function multi-pro tailgate. Nimnik Buick GMC has the largest inventory of GMC Sierras in the area. This month, save up to $10,000 off new GMC Sierra 1500 or enjoy rates as low as 1.9% APR financing. You get it at Nimnik GMC. We are professional grade.
The Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute is now offering online scheduling for new patient appointments for all of their positions. Simply schedule your appointment on your cell phone, tablet, or desktop. JOI is the first orthopedic practice in North Florida to offer this feature to patients. To schedule your appointment online, visit joi.net and click on the button at the top of the page. If you'll be using insurance, be sure and have your information handy. JOI, where the pros go.
Hey, I know we love our happy hours, but have you been to Mr. Chubby's Wings for lunch lately?
Yep, their new specials are awesome. I eat lunch there all the time.
I went this week and got wings, a drink, and chips for $8.
As usual, the best prices in town. You can't hardly find anyone doing $8 lunch anymore.
I know. I'm saving my money for the weekends with $8 lunch specials.
Save your money for the weekends. Enjoy $8 lunch specials Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. 3 locations serving you for all sports all year. Mr. Chubby's Wings, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Denny Thompson here. Tackle burglars and protect your turf. Give yourself peace of mind catching everything around your home with Tyson Sound & Security's cutting-edge surveillance cameras. For safety and convenience, Tyson has you covered for all home cameras and security systems. I'm talking HD recording, night vision, and remote alerts all from your phone or computer. Call Tyson Sound & Security right now at 904-762-1000. Tyson Sound & Security, security and automation experts.
Hey, stop paying for exterior paint that doesn't protect your home or business. Hicken here for my friends at Rhino Shield. Man, those beautifully durable coatings. And I'm telling you, they're beautiful and they're durable. They never chip, crack, or peel. You want that backed up? They back it up. 25-year warranty. Who does that? Rhino Shield. Prevents unsightly mold, mildew, and algae. Prevents water intrusion from those crazy storms that we get in Northeast Florida. Fights salt corrosion. Class A fire rating. And by the way, that's while saving you thousands compared to the cost of repainting over and over again. Getting 0% financing, up to 20% off right now. Great low pricing. Never been easier to paint your home with Rhino Shield. Take the first step today. Get your free estimate at rhinoshieldjax.com. Go to rhinoshieldjax.com. Sign up and get that free estimate and enjoy.
Clear water.
John, I can't even mow my side yard. It's so soggy. Man, my builder sucks.
Brent, calm down. This is a common problem in neighborhoods where houses are built too close together. You need gutters and a properly installed French drain that will soak up subsurface water. We can completely dry it up.
So I can take my builder off my speed dial now, huh?
Yeah, we got you, buddy. Let that builder bitterness go.
Clear water, irrigation,
and drainage too.
This State in Sports History is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 15, 1947, Jackie Robinson becomes the first African-American to play in U.S. Major League Baseball on the Dodgers.
Hey, Carline here. Tired of missing out on the conversation due to hearing loss? At Jacksonville Hearing and Balance, their team of audiologists led by Dr. Douglas Green can help you rediscover the joy of connection. Visit jhbi.org today.
Transmission troubles? I'm Robin Sidbury, owner of Action Transmission Specialist on Merrill Road. So come in and see how we can help solve your transmission troubles. We service all makes and models. Remember, get traction. Call Action at 744-0755.
Mueller Air Conditioning presents...
Are You Cool?
Today's challenger, a corporate management manager from Jacksonville, Florida. Meet Les Blankston.
Yeah, hi, Bob.
That is a remarkably beige suit there, Les. Tell us, why are you on the show?
Well, I just replaced my old air conditioner with a new one from Bueller, and I'm just so comfortable these days. I wondered, am I cool now?
Let's find out, Les. Go ahead and spin the wheel.
That's right, Les. By upgrading your old AC to a more energy-efficient model from Bueller Air Conditioning, you'll save money, save energy, and proudly show your family that
you are cool.
Do you think I should get a mohawk?
Pace yourself, Les.
Stay cooler with Bueller.
Visit BuellerAir.com.
Now that's what I call high-quality H2O.
If you want high-quality water throughout your home, call your local Water Boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. WaterboyJAX.com.
Are you 18 years or older? Just got married? Just got divorced or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700. Office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
All right, welcome back. Getting ready for the Coastal Equipment Guggen Open out here at Hidden Hills. Appreciate the boys having us out here, and appreciate Coastal Equipment. Appreciate the sponsors coming out today for a beautiful, beautiful day. It's warmed up nicely. It should be a great day of golf. Great day of fun out there. And
we have some pure athleticism on display. We just talked to PGA Tour winner Matt Every. I see former Jaguars cornerback Aaron Beasley making his way around. And then, of course, there's, you know, the Prosser Hicken tandem swing is something that's not seen everywhere.
Legendary.
You know.
So it should be a good day. Should be a lot of fun. We'll put the wraps on this
this program.
Terrific turnout, terrific hosts in the Coastal Equipment, you know, Guggen Open. It's balls in the ground.
Yeah, yeah.
The tradition like most.
Billy Joel, still miffed about last night, cut off during the piano, man.
He should be. This week, it's Billy Joel, man. I mean, we got to get things buttoned up here a little bit better than that.
CVS said 11 o'clock is 11 o'clock. Boom. Sing us a song, you know.
Yeah, let's go.
Welcome to news.
Yeah, Jaguars today is coming
local
up next.
News.
ET, take it quickie. Take it, take it, take
it. The piano man.
Take it.
Sing us the song.
The drill from the studios at Republic Services. We'll handle it from here.
What do you hear on the street these days, Huggy?
There was a time.